What a catch! McKayton touched it!
And we welcome you to Scott Stadium on the campus of the University of Virginia in Charlottesville, Virginia, for today's VHSL Class 6 Football State Championship featuring the Highland Spring Springers at 13-1 and the Freedom Prince William Eagles at 13-0. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the NFHS Network. We appreciate you joining us here for today's exclusive coverage here online at NFHSnetwork.com. I'm Andy Hayes, joined alongside Matt Hatfield. Good to have you with us here. Matt, boy, I tell you, not too often do you have two defending state champions playing in the Division VI state championship, but here we go. Freedom and Highland Springs, maybe the most anticipated game for the entire state throughout the whole season.
Ever since we knew Highland Springs was moving up from Class 5 to Class 6, this game has been circled as a potential matchup on the calendar. In fact, the regions even got together and decided 6A, 6B, 6C, 6D. We'll cross bracket, let you play potentially in the state finals. We've got a good one here at UVA.
They made the right choice.
They did.
We've got a great game coming up here. Let's talk a little bit about the path for both of these teams. They both had state semifinal games that weren't really very close. Yeah. Certainly when you watch them warm up, I mean, this is kind of like the alpha lion staring at the alpha lion here. So what do we expect here with the path from both sides? Who's had the tougher schedule? Who benefits from that here in this game?
I think Highland Springs has the tougher schedule so far on the body of work, Andy, but Freedom's only close game was one with Verona, who Highland Springs had a rally to beat, 35-27. They breezed by Madison, who they beat in the state championship a year ago in the semifinal round, also blasted Battlefield 50-7. This is an outfit under Coach Darrell Overton that's put up 59.3 points per game a year after setting the VHSL single-season record with 952 points. They are lethal. They've scored 35 every game, whereas Highland Springs has the one blemish. They lost to Maury, who we'll see later on in the Class 5 final, but it's always a team that's battle-tested under Coach Lauren Johnson.
I mean, the numbers offensively staggering, as you mentioned. You just don't see that very often. And here we are watching the Eagles coming out here in their white uniforms here today. Highland Springs wearing their all blacks. And in the pregame, we didn't have it on camera for you, but let me tell you, they were talking back and forth. I mean, this is the defending 6A champ, the defending 5A champ. Something's got to give here today. Predictions from you. I know you've already done that with your radio program. You felt like Freedom just too much for Highland Springs.
Yeah, I went with a score of 35-27 over the Springers, even though a couple of my writers and co-hosts have gone the other way with Highland Springs. But I will say this, Lauren Johnson's team has won 5 championships in the last 8 seasons, including the last one here at UVA back in 2015 over Stonebridge, who we'll see later on in the Class 5 final versus Maury. But if it is close, the Springers will have the confidence. I just don't know if they can stop this Freedom attack as we see the keys here.
Yeah, let's talk about it. Highland Springs, what are they going to have to do here to win this game and claim another state title?
Well, then they have to establish the tempo they want to play at the rate of speed. Can they get the running game going with Eric Bird, Ja'Kyrie Henley, also the quarterback who's going to Maryland, a dual threat in Christian Martin? Keep it close to the bottom of the end of the game. 51.3 points per game is the margin of victory for Freedom. Let them be in a tight battle to see if they can react to it. Highland Springs has been in some tough tussles with Verona, with Manchester, even Maury earlier this year. And ignore the noise. There's a lot of talk about Freedom being the best offense of all time in VHSL history. Block that out and play your game. Stick to the script and the game plan. For Freedom, pedal to the metal. Show why you are such a lethal attack with so many different weapons and why you've been able to do it at such a high clip under Coach Overton. Control the run game, because I think that is what sets up the pass for Highland Springs, and it also allows them to control the flow of the game and spread the wealth. They have 5 players with Juju Preston, Aaron Duncan, Cam Courtney, E.J. Reed, and Jeff Overton that have combined for over 200 catches. Get them all involved so Highland Springs can't key in on just one guy.
Well, you see both teams on the field. It's going to be Highland Springs football to start, so we'll get a chance to see the talented offense for the Springers, led by quarterback Christian Martin, 6'4", 218-pounder. And we watched him last year really play great in the playoffs, led his team to a state title. This defense for Freedom, how do they match up a little bit against this Highland Springs offense? Matt, what do you think?
They're very speedy and athletic. A lot of guys go both ways, though, Andy. So we'll see Aaron Duncan off the edge. We talked about Courtney and Overton in the secondary. How will they hold up if this thing is a meat grinder type of game, third, fourth quarter, one score, one possession battle? That's going to be the key, and they have to be disciplined when Lauren Johnson and company go to that option run game where they can mix it up with the pitch and the handoffs with Eric Bird and also Christian Martin keeping it.
So just about ready to rock and roll here. Live from UVA and Scott Stadium, number 4, E.J. Reed will kick it. It's a low kick, and it'll be fielded back at the 20. by the Springers. Looking to move out to about the 31 is Jamon Lewis. And that's where Highland Springs will start. First and 10. We'll bring in the third member of our broadcast crew here today, Jack Hayes. Jack, I know you've been excited about this game as well. Your thoughts on this one?
I've definitely been looking forward to this game all week. When we were told that Highland Springs and Freedom will be playing in the 6A final, I've had this one circled on my calendar all week, so I'm excited to see how this game goes down here. This will be a fun one to watch.
Springer's coming out. They've got three wides to start here. And then one runs off the field. So we'll go with a slot back kind of right off the edge. In motion. Darryl Harris, check that. Kyrie Henry, here's the option play. Martin will pitch it back. And this is a six-yard gain right off the bat for Eric Bird, who's the leading rusher for the Springers. Matt Hatfield, you highlighted him in your preview. Here, let's talk a little bit about what he does well.
He's got a little bit of a mix of power and speed. 1,573 yards, 19 TD runs on the season, and he's only a 10th grader, Andy. Checks in at 5'8", 180 pounds. Really, they've gone through him at times to set the tone of their offense here. And second and four, this allows them to open up the playbook, maybe some option, maybe a quick screen. Watch out for Henley in the slot. He is lethal.
Second down and about five. Here's Martin back to pass. Going to throw it deep, and it's incomplete.
This Freedom secondary, Andy, has a bunch of different guys. Ja'Kai Hughes getting the start at corner on the outside. When you look at some of those speedy weapons they have on offense, they double with E.J. Reed, who's going to Wake Forest. Cam Courtney and Indiana commit, the strong safety, number five. Jeff Overton, the ballyhooed running back, who's just a junior with 2,000-plus yards. He plays strong safety, so a lot of confidence in those DBs.
Third down and four. Martin in the shotgun. Man-to-man coverage here. The handoff will go to Bird. And he slides by a defender at the line of scrimmage. He's about a yard short. Decision time here for Lauren Johnson. Does he want to go for it this early on and potentially give
I think you were going to say Freedom the short field here if they don't get it. But fourth and one, this could be a quick sneak for Martin. Maybe a Jalen Hurts type of, what do they say? It's the push here?
Yeah, the tush-push, that's
tush
right.
Tush-push, yeah.
Here's the give. Nowhere to go. Straight ahead. And that's going to be Freedom football now. Flag flies.
Andy, I like the decision to go for it, but I don't like out a shotgun there. I want to go under center with the quarterback as opposed to just handing it off with the shotgun play. Now we'll see what the flag is. Springers seem to be encouraged by what the call may be. Freedom maybe not so much. Oh, they're going to say it's first down. Freedom. Personal foul, I think, after the play was over is going to be the whistle. So it looks like Freedom will have the football, but, Andy, the personal foul is going to be on the Eagles after the play was over there. Again, I like the call by Lauren Johnson to go for it. I don't like, though, out of shotgun there. I want to get understand with the quarterback and sneak it up ahead with his size.
So a big opportunity here for Freedom right out of the gate. Again, some laundry on the field, not really a surprise as we saw these two teams jawing back and forth in the pregame. So believe me when we tell you that the emotions are going to be high today for both sides.
Well, that penalty's big because it takes you out of Highland Springs territory now at your own 46, although the Freedom offense at 59.3 points per game, they're not afraid to go 50, 60 yards in one play.
Jeff Overton to the right, Tristan Evans Trulio, and it's Evans taking the carry straight up the middle. Still on his feet, 30, 25, 20, and knocked out of bounds there. Huge gain on first down. And the Eagles are set up in the red zone.
I'm sure, Andy, that Tristan Evans, who's the now all-time touchdown pass record holder in VHSL history, breaking the mark of Phillip Sims, who we watched a couple decades ago. Watch him here on this keeper. He heard about Christian Martin being a dual threat. He's showing here with some intelligence and the ability to scoot to the outside. Now they're in the red zone in one play. That's what Freedom's offense does.
So first and 10 from the 20. Motion man, and now they'll hand it off to Overton up the middle, and a whistle. Penalty flag is down. Looks like a little bit of motion by the offense. It'll be a 5-yard penalty on Freedom.
Penalty is something that Freedom has to watch out for here. They've got a big offensive line. You see number 77 there, one of the key members in the trenches, Walter Hughes, the center. Also, Jonah Fuga, right tackle. We watched his brother Josh Fuga, went to Virginia Tech. He was a big enforcer on the defensive line. They want to go up the middle, up right, and then even at left tackle, Jules Stanley to go with Mayu Talia and Justice Robinson, the guards. They can pull out.
I mean, Matt, let's be honest. If Highland Springs can slow down this Freedom offense, they might be the first. These guys have run over everyone they've played in the last 2 years. I think they're at 28 straight games. Is that accurate?
That's right. Yeah. And they haven't scored less than 35 in any of those games. The only teams that keep them pretty much under 40 were Verona and Stonebridge, who have really good defenses. So holding them under 40 is a feat in itself.
Incredible blend of speed and athleticism, but really, and I think you'll agree with this, that Evans doesn't get enough credit for how he throws the football. Everybody talks about Overton and these wide receivers like E.J. Reed, but the reality is Evans is the guy that kind of makes it all work because of his legs, his arm, his savvy back there in the pocket, and he kind of makes the whole magic happen. So you saw that on that first run. And after that long run, a 5-yard penalty against Freedom. So the Eagles, first and 15 from the 25. Motion man is Reed. Here's Evans. He pumps. Now he's looking down the field. And this one is going to be almost caught. What an effort. It was well covered by Highland Springs. Ezekiel Burchett was right there. And it looks like the intended receiver is still down for Freedom. I'll watch it one more time.
A one-on-one matchup they like a lot here, Andy. You've got Juju Preston in the slot, but they're going to throw the jump ball. And just it was lobbed up there pretty high, and you see Preston reacting to his teammate going down. I didn't catch if that was Duncan or possibly another receiver. It might have been E.J. Reed, number four, on the outside there. They also have Jeff Overton, number six, and Cam Courtney, number five. So many weapons there, but that's one they like to get back because they usually make the play on that.
Still down in the end zone here. That'll give us a chance to tell you who is behind the scenes on our production here today. Our producer for the 16th year, doing state championship broadcasts and productions with us, Helene Shane. We've got Ryan Dalgerda up here on the top camera. I think Ryan's been here over a decade with us. Great to have him back this year as well. And we've got the young guy down on the field, Owen Hayes, helping to bring that field shot to you from the end zone. So Andy Hayes, Jack Hayes, and Matt Hatfield with you. Matt, you had a chance to do one with the other rookie last week, the Maury game, right?
We watched Maury mighty impressive, 55-0 against Indian River. And you do wonder, some people saying, can we cross-bracket these championship games? Can we get, you know, Highland Springs, Stonebridge again, Freedom, Maury? Watch those two offenses go at it. You never know in the future. Maybe they play an out-of-district game next year.
Well, at the half, Matt and I will give you a breakdown of this game coming up later on today at 5 o'clock. That'll be a good one. Out of the timeout from the injury here, 2nd and 15. And Evans will pull it, makes a great read up to the 15, down to the 13. And tremendous run right there and decision by Tristan Evans.
Evie is really shining through here in this first drive for them offensively, Andy. And that offensive line, watch the push again up front. You see Hughes at center, gets the snap, and then he gets to the second level to get a block there on number 24, I think it is, for Highland Springs. That's the inside linebacker, Kasim Drumgoal. If you get to the second level with your blockers, it's going to make it easy for these speedsters.
3rd and 4. Evans hands it off. Running to the left side. Courtney toward the end zone. Touchdown, Freedom. And the Eagles are on the board first.
They can hit you vertically. They can hit you side to side, east to west. And we watch it here, east to west. Little jet action. Get to the left side. You see the block being delivered here with Overton, who usually gets the touchdown runs. This time it's going to be his mate, Courtney, finding pay dirt and an easy touchdown for this Freedom offense, which is off and racing here. Just 2.5 minutes in, and they're going to go for two, it looks like, Andy.
So Evans is the holder. He's standing back there. Now they switch into the extra point formation. Here's the kick. It's a low kick, and it's up and in. Wouldn't call that prototypical kicker style, but it worked. Freedom up 7-0. We'll step aside for a quick break. We'll come right back after this quick word.
With great brands at the best prices at Academy Sports and Outdoors, you'll always find more fun. More of this and this. And more of this and this. So you can do more of that. And that. And that. And definitely some of that. While getting together for more of that. That. And that. Yes! Have more fun with great brands at the best prices. Only at Academy Sports and Outdoors.
Welcome back here to Scott Stadium on the campus of UVA. We thank Academy for their support of VHSL Athletics and our state championship coverage here. Andy Hayes, Matt Hatfield, Jack Hayes with you. Class 6 football championship leading things off a little earlier this year than in years past, 11:30 kick. And Freedom has gotten off to a fast start, leading 7-0.
That just means they can score 2-3 touchdowns before 12 noon, right?
I mean, that's, yes, probably more. We've seen this offense be pretty dynamic over the last couple years. So another low kick. And it'll be fielded back at about the 20 again. Bird straight ahead, out past the 35 to the 37. So good field position for Highland Springs. Well, let's say this, Matt. I mean, on the other side, Highland Springs is not used to having people come right at them and jump ahead by very much either. So, you know, that's something that we've seen for many years under Coach Johnson. This team is tough defensively. They make adjustments. Well, they can score, too. So it's a big drive, though, right here.
Well, and I go back to their game with Maury early in the season. They were down in that game, and Maury got an early lead, and they battled back in the second half and had a chance to go in front in that game. So this team knows how to respond from adversity, and I think Christian Martin's going to take a couple shots potentially this drive if they get the matchups one-on-one they like.
Run to the left side. Not much there. Maybe a loss of a yard. Good defense by Reeves, junior middle linebacker for Freedom, wearing number 10 right there in your screen.
103 tackles for Reeves coming in, 11 for loss. He's got a couple of forced fumbles on the year. He's really an enforcer for them, along with Isaiah Harper. Saw them play last year regular season against Stonebridge, and he had the eye black. He looked like a mean warrior out there playing linebacker.
Martin, back to pass, throws a slant, incomplete. And the closest guy to catching that might have been E.J. Reed, the defensive back.
Yeah, he had George Lovelace, the intended receiver there, blanketed on that play in coverage. I'm curious to see if we do see Tamondre Braxton suit up, Andy, for the Springers. He's number 2. I understand he was questionable coming in with an injury. He is a key factor for them. Word I got was he was unlikely to suit up in this game. So without him, they have to go deeper into the receiving bag. Henley's going to play more there. Noah Jenkins, a Virginia Tech committed defensive back, and also Lovelace have to step up on third down to make receptions and keep drives going.
Motion man for the Springers. Kevin Finney. Two to either side here from Martin. Back to pass. Nowhere to go. It's going to scramble. Now throws it down the field. And this one is incomplete. Tipped and almost intercepted back in the backside by Overton, who was playing from his safety position. Read that perfectly. Well, it's going to be fourth down and 11.
Again, the coverage here, you got two receivers to each side. On the near side, you got the likes of Henley and Noah Jenkins. There's nowhere to go. The secondary is doing a great job for Freedom with Courtney and Hughes on the near side. Martin's going to scramble there and just heave it up where there's three white shirts in the way. And remember, we watched Kendall Bannister last year in the secondary. I know you loved him, went to Ohio. He locked things up on the back end for this Freedom defensive backfield. They lose him, and their secondary seems to be just as good, if not better.
Playing great so far. There's the kick, almost blocked. And get it away, it'll bounce at the 33. And roll down to about the 22-yard line of Freedom. So the Eagles will have it first and 10 there. Yeah, I remember Bannister, his performance in that state championship game was unbelievable. And you sit back and you think about those kind of performances and how they change your life. And, you know, how much confidence they give you as a young person. When you come out here and play on this stage at the highest level in front of all the folks out there watching, man, I tell you, you remember that for the rest of your life.
Memories that will last a lifetime for sure. Now Freedom here, Andy, they get the ball back. Even though they're inside their own 25, you see the two receivers to each side. They could heave it on first down and see if they can get the separation against the Highland Springs secondary that the Springers are searching for on offense themselves.
Two wides to either side for Evans in the shotgun. Quick toss out to the edge, caught at the 20. Some running room to the 30. 35, it knocked out of bounds hard at about the 32-yard line. That was Preston. Carlton Preston with a nice gain. It'll move the chains. We watch this. Nice little block on the edge, too.
Yeah, right tunnel screens. We see that great block delivered there by number 55, Jules Stanley. This is a young man, Andy. They call him Juju. Carlton Preston, 65 catches for 1,229 yards and 18 touchdowns. Just a junior and just committed last weekend to Clemson in the ACC.
Not a bad place to go play football.
Yeah, they've had some pretty good receivers. Sammy Watkins comes to mind. Yeah. And DeAndre Hopkins with their, yep. Yeah, Mike Williams. Yeah.
Here's the give to Overton. Racing, stiff arm, throws a man down. He's up the sideline to the 50, down to the 45, and another penalty flag comes flying on the bench there of Highland Springs.
Getting a little chippy, and we didn't see that last year, Andy. We saw him make some moves that were Reggie Bush-esque, but look at the mean stiff arm he delivers as he gets to the outside. He's playing with some grit and some fearlessness.
And we can talk about all of these guys today on the field, but there's one guy that can go anywhere he wants, and that's number 6 right there.
Hard to dispute that. I mean, think about what he's done in the playoffs alone. 947 yards and 16 TDs. There are a lot of backs. You know this, Jack. You played the game. How many backs like to have that in a season? He did that in the playoffs, and it's not even done yet. Playoffs!
That's unreal. Almost 1,000 yards in the playoffs is pretty unheard of.
Andy, he'll get there today. When the day's over, he'll get over that mark, I'm pretty sure.
Well, and again, you know, the passing game's working. That's really this only the second run we saw. The first one there was a penalty on, so... The penalty on this play is against Freedom. It'll move the run back, and it won't be a first down. It'll be second down and about 2. It'll be a yard and a half here for the Eagles.
But this is 3 down territory for them where they're set up at this point.
If you're Coach Overton, though, you got to have a talk with your team and say, look, we're hurting ourselves here with these penalties.
No question.
It's 2 unsportsmanlike calls. Motion. By Preston, quick toss near side. Caught. Spin move at the 40, going nowhere is Cameron Courtney. Good defense that time by the Springers. Number 24, Kasim Drumgoal.
Like the trio there, Drumgoal. Also, you see in the picture, 52, Nicholas Jones. And number 11, remember that kid, Brennan Johnson Jr., nicknamed Peanut. That's Lauren Johnson's son. He is a mighty good one, was defensive player of the year in the state a season ago, and only a junior. He did that a season ago as a sophomore, Andy. He's going to be a great one for the Springers for a couple more, for another season, and then I think in college as well.
Johnson on top of Overton on that tackle, but he's going to have the first down past the 45 to the 47, so that'll move the chains. One of the Eagles lost their helmet, so he'll have to run off the field. But you see the strength of Overton. You know, we talked about the speed right last year, the elusiveness. It looks like he's put on some muscle in the weight room, and he's carrying folks with him. That stiff arm you mentioned, I mean, that's the evolution of his game right now, Matt, compared to a year ago.
A lot of great backs in the 2025 class in Virginia. We got one later on in the state championship with Liberty Christian's Gideon Davidson, but he's at the top of the class.
Chucking it deep, and a little bit too far for Preston. I love the way Coach Overton calls his offense. I mean, they will take the 5-yard route. They'll do the quick bubble screens. They'll wear you out on a quick little inside run. And then, boom, they're going up top trying to get the big one. And a lot of times they're successful with that strategy.
Well, I'm fascinated that chess match of his offense being so complex, how Lauren Johnson is defensive coordinator, Devon Simmons, who's one of the best around, how they adjust and what moves they make, maneuvers, because there's so much to prepare for and defend with this Freedom offense. How do you slow them down? That's the task today.
Second and 10. Evans will keep it. And going nowhere. Swarm of black and gold. Uniforms there on top of him. Led by Johnson.
A lot of pride on this defensive front. You see right there, Johnson gets to it. Also number 42 get to him initially. Rikai Hopkins. He's like a linebacker, defensive, and a hybrid. Now they're in third and long, which Freedom hardly ever sees.
Evans back to pass on third down. South. Back at the 46. That time, big number 99, Joshua Clayton, getting in there. 6'2", 270-pound senior.
fresh body on that defensive line. You have to rotate those bodies in. He's not even one of the main starters at D-tackle with Jaden Schuler and Nick Jones, but we see them going to the bench here, and the offensive line for Freedom's done a better job in run blocking than pass protection so far. If Highland Springs can get pressure on Evans, it changes up the whole picture dramatically.
So fourth and 10, maybe a quick kick here. I don't know. We'll see. Nobody back for Highland Springs.
They've only punted four times this year, the whole year.
Maybe it's not a quick kick for them. They tried to get Highland Springs offside. They almost did. But they have to call a timeout. So this might be the fifth punt of the year, Matt.
That's a crazy thing to think. They've only punted four times in 13 games. I mean,
nuts.
There are teams that do four in a game. But with fourth and 10, do you want to give it back to Lauren Johnson, all the momentum? He went for it on fourth and one. They didn't get it. Springer's going to stop here. You're right back in the ballgame, can tie it up, and now this becomes a seesaw type of battle. It's a really interesting call what you do here. Fourth and five or less, I'm going for it. But 10 yards to get, even as explosive as his offense is, I'm not sure this is the right move.
Let's just lay it out like this. If Highland Springs is in this game and it's close in the fourth quarter, they got a great shot to win it. If Freedom is able to jump up by two or three touchdowns, obviously the Eagles typically cruise from that point forward. So a decision like this right here is absolutely crucial. And it looks like they will punt it. I think that's the right call.
I do too. I mean, I think he thought it over. And look, you're going to get enough chances to score with your offense, and you'll have the ball more. Don't get greedy here.
Good kick, angling back to about the 20. Fielded there by Henley, and Henley stopped immediately at the 24-yard line. So that's where Highland Springs will take back over.
Andy, we've watched some special players for Highland Springs on the outside over the years. Greg Dortch comes to mind now with the Arizona Cardinals. Kevon Wallace, who played at Clemson, by the
yep,
way.
Yep.
And they were lethal going over the top. If Highland Springs can get one of those plays on special teams, you know, a block punt, a kickoff return, a punt return, it can really be that third phase of the game that allows them to compete to the very end against this high-octane Freedom attack. And now I think they'll go back to the running game here. They saw what they had against the secondary. See if they can establish the run, put an extra guy in the box, and then try play action from there.
So Martin in the shotgun with three wides to the near side. Handoff goes to Bird up the middle. Breaking a tackle. Breaking another one, and now he's out to the 30. Solid first down run by Eric Bird, who has really carried the offense on the ground game here this year. And you can see why right here.
And with Jules Stanley, number 55's helmet popping off, he has to go off the field for a play. So another sub will come in on the defensive front for Freedom, and this could be another opportunity with it being second and short to medium for Lauren Johnson to try to pound the rock up the gut with Bird and see if his interior line can get that push they're looking for.
Second down and four for Highland Springs. Martin back to pass, gonna throw it up. Oh, it's picked off! Eagles have got it, racing to the end zone. Jackson Hughes, touchdown, Eagles! Ja'Kai Jackson Hughes, 37 yards, and a penalty flag is down, so hold on, but this was an ill-advised pass by Martin, and Jackson Hughes was staring right at him. He was right there to take it. Great block down the field right here. A no block, good decision not to get him from the back there by Overton. Looks like the penalty is going to go against Highland Springs, Matt.
And you know what? Ja'Kai Hughes got the start last week, six tackles and a pick. He gets a pick here again. The TD's good. He read that all the way, and Martin wants to get that one back. He's getting ready to go down, and the biggest rule as a quarterback is don't throw it up for grabs, and that time he did. To Martin's credit, all year long in the last season as well, he only had one or two picks a year ago. This season coming in, he's been a very good, judicious decision maker. It's only his third interception the whole year, but that's when he'd like to get back.
It's tough because, you know, you want to make plays, and we get that. Everybody can understand it, but in this game, one or two of those could really put you down by a lot. And as we've already seen, Freedom, very opportunistic, not only on offense, but also defense. So they're up 13 to nothing. DJ Reed will go back to kick this one through. Evans going to fake it, and it's going to get tackled back at the 19. So no good on the extra point. Darrell Harris, the linebacker, coming up with the tackle there. Good job by him. And they'll keep it at 13-0 Freedom.
Well, two possessions, no first downs for the Springers to begin the game. They have a chance to get something rolling, and the Freedom defense able to score for them. There's no panic, really calm on the sideline for the Springers and Lauren Johnson. It is a 13-point game. They can overcome the deficit, but it starts now with this drive coming up, because if you give it back to them three and out or you turn it over, now Freedom's starting to really get rolling with some momentum.
Great crowd there for both sides. Saw the band of Freedom playing here. Springers coming out in full force. Not that far away from Charlottesville.
How nice is it to be back here at UVA? It's our first championship game since 2015. We've been at Old Dominion, Hampton. Of course, there's other locations around the state. Salem's got championships today, Class 1 and Class 2. Liberty's got championships. Beautiful campus there, Class 3 and Class 4. But it's really cool what the VHSL does, having so many different colleges around the state get to host these. We were even at one at Virginia Tech back in 2008. So
long time ago, but it was fun. And it is a great time to come be a part of this atmosphere, the college campuses for the high school kids. I think is one of the great things for championship football. Makes it feel big time, right? So kudos to UVA for coming back and hosting these games. I know we're having fun. Here's Reed's kick. It's going to be fielded back at the 40. Lewis up the sideline, inside of Freedom territory, down to the 45, and knocked out hard out of bounds there.
A big hit as he went to the sideline. I tell you what, this is a big boy game, and you're seeing some big hits. Watch this return as he gets it at the 40. And now Highland Springs has to feel a little bit better about itself. They don't have to go as far to reach pay dirt here at the 36-yard line. We talked about the return game helping them out here. If they can make the field shorter for them, longer for Freedom, very simple game. It makes it a lot easier for them to get back in this thing.
It's a very, very important drive for Highland Springs. Great field position. Coming off of a big pick six, Christian Martin in offense needs to respond here, and a timeout will be called by Coach Overton. Second one today from Freedom.
I don't think he's pressed with just having one remaining in the half, knowing how quickly his team can strike from anywhere on the field. And now it's really the first challenge for the Freedom defense. They got the interception a moment ago, pick six from Ja'Kai Jackson-Hughes. Now if Highland Springs gets back to their running game, you know, Martin had one miscue, but you wipe it clean. As a quarterback in this game, you have to have a short-term memory, because if you hang on to it, another one will come and another one will come. We saw that happen last year in a lot of ways to Maury against Highland Springs. Remember, they had the early interception. Maury Miller got picked. It was a pick six, and the Springers got cruising from there. You can't really dwell on the mistake. Wipe the slate clean. Turn the page. Let's go.
Across the state, we've got Tim Blank and Marquez Davila doing the Class 1 and 2 games for you. Right here on the NFHS Network, Justin Waddell, Bob Duncan, and Robert Andrews doing the Division 3 and 4, Class 3 and 4 games. So we'll be checking out those. You got a couple scores for us, don't you, Matt, already?
Yeah, first quarter in the books. Phoebus leads Salem 7-0, but the Spartans have it around midfield to begin the second quarter. And here the Springers give it with Eric Bird again. But we see multiple white shirts again here, Andy, for the Freedom defense, although Bird does not go down on the first hit. We're learning that quickly.
Overton on the tackle. He tried to pull the ball out, but Bird was holding on fiercely.
They were in a battle. I watched it a couple weekends ago on Thanksgiving weekend against Manchester in the Region 6A final. They got some timely takeaways in the red zone, and that was really a game, a gut check for them, where Bird had to run the ball. Henley creative on some sweeps as well. I'd keep an eye on him in the slot on the far side of your screen up top with also up there. They've been using a couple different receivers, including George Lovelace.
Handoff again to Bird, and not going anywhere there. Again on the tackle for Freedom, number 10, Devin Reeves. He's been all over the field today. So third down and 7 coming up.
Yeah, Reeves is an all-state level player for a reason. Last year, Isaiah Harper had a pick six in the title game. They got Jewel Harris, number 8, you see there, right near the football. He's the region defensive player of the year in 6B. Cardinal District stud on that defensive line. And third down and 7. Springer's trying to get the first down here so they don't have to think about a fourth down situation and what to do.
Yeah. Martin in the shotgun. Back to pass. Looking down the field, and this one thrown towards the end zone, but not in the right spot. And it'll be incomplete. Closest guy to it was Ja'Kai Jackson Hughes. It'll be fourth down and 7. My assumption here is that they'll go for it. Matt, don't you think?
I would think so. A punt doesn't really net you much in terms of a return. And, you know, it's easy to say Martin was just way off on that game, on that throw. But these receivers aren't getting the separation they need against this defensive backfield. It's really plain and simple. There's nowhere for him to go with the football. Now you wonder here, if nobody's open, does Christian Martin think more about taking off and running, using his legs to extend the plays?
That's really where we saw last year in the playoffs. He started to take over games, you know, and he'd pull it down and go. Some big drives. I remember that against Stonebridge in the semis and then the championship game. And there'll be a timeout called by Coach Johnson. So Highland Springs will talk it over. We'll step aside for a quick break and a quick word from our title sponsor here today, Academy Sports.
This presentation of the NFHS Network is brought to you by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Have fun out there.
And we welcome you back here in the timeout. Coach Johnson talking things over here with his offense. Fourth down, 7 to go. Springers are trailing 13 to nothing. Andy Hayes, Matt Hatfield, and Jack Hayes with you, live from Scott Stadium on the campus of UVA. One of two games here today. At 5 o'clock, we'll see Maury and Stonebridge, round 3 between those two.
Every 2 years, 2019 right. Was Maury's, 2021 was Stonebridge's. We'll find out whose it is today.
Here's Martin back to pass. Looking across the middle. Tipped away by Jackson Hughes.
That time it was on the money, Andy. It was a catchable pass by Christian Martin to Ja'Kyrie Henley, but an even better play made by the secondary as we watch Hughes with his second splendid step-up play. He had the pick, the last possession. Here it is right there, inside post. Henley's going to usually come up with that, but breaking in on it was Ja'Kai Jackson Hughes, who has been just outstanding today. And the defensive backfield right now of Freedom has been the difference-making unit through about 9 minutes of play here at UVA.
All I can tell you, and size might be a little bit of a hurdle for the biggest level, but I've seen guys at 5'8", 165 play great college football. And Ja'Kai Jackson Hughes has got all the skill sets as a corner on display here today. Here's Tristan Evans. He'll pull it. He's got some running room, still on his feet, and hit out at the 45. That'll move the chains for a first down.
They had some good quarterbacks before at Freedom, Quest Powell, and other Division I caliber players, but Tristan Evans, I feel like he's underappreciated, like you said, Andy, and so much is talked about for Freedom, understandably so, his passing ability, but he's a pretty good runner, as he's showing here in his first quarter.
Gibb goes to Overton now. Still running out to about the 49. Good defense there by Drum Goal for the Springers. It'll be second down at about 6.
I feel like they're patiently setting it up for a strike down the field right now with their offense. But the Highland Springs secondary and coverage, to their credit, they're playing off here, giving them a lot of room, those receivers, to spread the field here and attack underneath.
Evans on a quick toss underneath to Reed. Reed hit hard at the 47 of Highland Springs. And knocked down there. He's going to be shy of the first down. About third down and 2 yards. Two minutes left here, first quarter. This has been a long first quarter, Matt.
It has, and you know, ordinarily you would think that benefits Highland Springs here, but they've had a couple of missed chances. They had the missed chance a moment ago, the interception. Freedom able to get the stop on fourth down. They've made the timely plays at this point.
Handoff, Overton's got the first down on his feet. And still rumbling down to about the 30. That'll put Freedom in great field position once again.
You know what? When you have a luxury like two players of the year on your team, Cardinal District Player of the Year was Tristan Evans, and you got the regional and reigning state player of the year, and Jeff Overton hit the B button on the video game on the Madden, and that's what Jeff Overton did with the spin move. You know about that, Jack, right? You hit the B button all the time when you beat your brother, don't you?
No doubt. Madden, okay. Madden's definitely my game. When Owen and I play,
take him behind the woodshed. That's right. There you go.
It's the only thing he does.
Yeah. Owen wants to get back, though. He can't comment right now.
Here's a give to Overton. That one going nowhere. Good tackle there for Highland Springs. Number 57, Jaden Schuler. Knocking Overton down right away.
Yeah, this defensive line has not been that bad for Highland Springs. It's just a matter of can they get more consistent pass rush with the way the Freedom offense operates. It's a lot of quick, timely throws. You're not dropping back, you know, chucking it deep all the time. They're very precise with what they do on offense.
Overton again. Gets free inside the 20 to the 10. Touchdown, Eagles. Jeff Overton. What a run.
Made it look easy. We watched Jeff Overton patiently. You know, a lot of backs were trying to make that extra move, too much dancing around. He lets the guy go down, sees him go down, and then attacks right from there.
Bounces off of his own guy. And then once he got to the edge, you can say goodnight. 19 to nothing. Freedom trying to make it 20.
Believe that's his 41st rushing touchdown of the year. And by the way, he came into this game 679 yards shy of the Prince William County record for career rushing yards. Has another season to go, by the way.
Unbelievable. 20 to nothing our score. We'll be right back. You're watching the VHSL State Football Championships right here on the NFHS Network. Scott Stadium here on the campus of UVA, the VHSL Classic Football, Six Football Championship here. 20 to nothing Freedom over Highland Springs. That's not a typo. It's been that kind of first half here for the Springers. They have seen this offense for Freedom hitting on all cylinders. Jeff Overton with a touchdown run a moment ago. Here's Henley on the return for Highland Springs, past the 35 to the 40. And the Springers will start right there, but it's been slow going for that offense, Matt Hatfield, of the Springers. They've not been able to do much.
No, they haven't, and I think a lot of it's going to come down to will and determination here, because the passing game has not been in a smooth rhythm here, clicking. You have to really slow this thing down, and it's been a slow-moving first quarter, but use the running game and see if you can keep the Freedom offense off the field for about a 14-16 play, one of those long drives, because the way we're watching things unfold, I don't know that their receivers can get a lot of separation and breakaway from these Freedom DBs.
First and 10. Martin will fake the pitch, run it to the 42, maybe out to the 44. They'll give him a nice spot. It'll be second down and about seven here for Highland Springs.
I think they'll let the clock run out here in this first quarter.
Yeah. I think Highland Springs will be happy to get this first quarter over with. Yeah.
Very much.
So there you have it. End of one. We'll be back with more coverage right after this. Freedom leading 20 to nothing.
High school sports fans, relive your favorite moments. Just click the shopping cart below the video player to get your digital copy today.
High school sports fans, relive your favorite moments. Just click the shopping cart below the video player to get your digital copy today.
Quarter break. On second down, Highland Springs stopped there on the run. Springers, Raymond Varner on the carry. It'll be third down and long here. Andy Hayes, Matt Hatfield with you, Jack Hayes as well. All freedom in the first quarter of action. Maybe the longest first quarter we've ever had in the state championship call together. What do you think?
Well, it feels that way. If you're Highland Springs, you're just saying, how do we get to halftime where we have a chance in this thing? Because Freedom is, they've reacted to a little bit of a methodical grind. You wouldn't think that the Eagles would stand up to that because they want to play so fast and loose and get up, you know, hit these bomb plays. But their defense has stood up today. The secondary and then also the linebackers like Devin Reeves making sticks. And once again here, Christian Martin getting no room to run.
He's going to be tackled at the 46. And he's going to be about 5 yards shy of the first down. Again, we talk about the offense all the time of the Freedom Eagles, but it's really been the defense here today that's given nothing to Highland Springs.
Jules Stanley, then also watch number six there, Jeff Overton. We just watched him score a touchdown. He's going out there to make a tackle on defense. He's pretty much been playing every snap on defense the last several weeks for Coach Overton's team and showing he's a well-rounded football player, not just a one-trick pony that can do one thing. He's got a lot of skill.
Real Dent, the punter for Highland Springs, on. And he'll boot it away. High kick, but short. It's going to hit down at about the 30, roll inside the 20. Freedom will take over at their own 19. In most cases, you'd feel pretty comfortable with that, but not with Freedom.
No.
I don't care where they are. They can hit a home run at any point on the field.
Well, I'm trying to remember the last time Highland Springs has been behind 20 points or more in a football game. It certainly hasn't been something that comes to mind during this run of dominance with five state championships in the last 8 years under Lauren Johnson, and they've played some quality teams. In fact, early this year, their first game out of the gate was Miramar, Lauren Johnson's alma mater in Florida, a 20-14 physical defensive battle that they pulled out.
I've never seen it. I mean, you're saying you haven't seen it very often. I've never seen it.
And Freedom might not be done, by the way, because I don't think they're going to sit on the ball and just become conservative all of a sudden.
Overton up the middle, running through tacklers. Now past the 20 to the 23-yard line. I think the strength of number six is really a big difference between this year and last year. And as a college coach, I'm sure they'd love to see that, right? That means he's in the weight room working, getting better. Here's Evans rolling out. He'll be caught by Preston.
Well, and to follow up on that, Andy, I mean, one of the questions that was asked by college coaches was, is he a running back? Is he a defensive back? Is he a slot back? Because he played a lot in the slot last year. Now he's showing the ability to run between the tackles.
Yeah, I agree.
And that takes him to another level when you're just not a guy that has to get to the outside and use your speed. He's showing more elements to his game, and that's how you go from good to great, great to elite. And I think that's what he's striving for. You know, the family name, his uncles, his dad play, all these people in his family haven't played football. He wants to be the best of the best.
Third and one here for the Eagles, and the give will go to Overton. Yeah, he went nowhere that time.
Speaking of families playing, Lauren Johnson was a heck of a player back at Virginia Tech in the day. His son Braylon's now a DB for the Hokies, and Brennan Johnson says, all right, I'm going to show you what I'm all about here at linebacker. He's been really making things happen. Without him wrapping up, that's Overton getting a first down, and now the Springers have a chance to get the football back and do something here before things get out of reach. Let's circle that play if they start to make a rally. That tackle by Brennan on third down was big, although Freedom could go for it here.
Fourth and one from their own 29. Evans in the shotgun. He's going to snap it. He gives it off to Overton. He's got running room to the near side. Look out. It's a foot race. Overton to the 45. 40 hurdles a man to the 20. Touchdown. Freedom. Oh, my. What a run.
Did he just do that?
You mentioned the name Reggie Bush, and we just saw a Reggie Bush-like run. Unbelievable.
72 yards to the house. Let's watch it again here, Andy. All right, he's going to get to the outside, get a first down. That's nice. But he says, all right, I'm going to hit the Y button on the video game controller. Hurdle, I'm gone. Last 20 yards, piece of cake. Jeffrey Overton Jr., ladies and gentlemen. I think he's cementing himself as one of the best running backs we've seen in Virginia in quite some time.
Unbelievable run. Ran right into our camera. Man, Owen Hayes' shot down there. Whoa, was that a beautiful run. Freedom's going to go for two. And they get it, right side.
Why not give it back to the guy? He just did a touchdown. He can do it all right now.
Unbelievable.
It's as good as it gets right there. It really is.
Let's watch that run one more time. We get a chance. And yeah, this was fourth and one from their own 29. I mean, this would have been a huge stop for Highland Springs. We'll go back to that here in a moment. Again, watch this, Matt. They seal down here on the offensive line. Great block right there. And that was tremendous on the edge to give Overton some running room by Stanley Jackson. And then that hurdle right there. I mean, that's incredible.
I don't think he was satisfied with what he did last year when he ran for 212 yards and three TDs on 23 carries against Madison in the state finals at Old Dominion. I think he wants, like I said, even more. Be better. Be better tomorrow than you were today. Be better today than you were yesterday.
Hilly's out free, almost. Had a lane. Tackled down at the 45. Wow. If he had gotten through that, he was gone.
Well, and if it wasn't for Jewel Harris making that tackle, the Region 6B Defensive Player of the Year, also playing special teams, guys have to do multiple phases on this Freedom football team. You know, you look at the sidelines, Andy, Highland Springs has more guys, actual players, than Freedom does. But it's the quality of the quantity that Freedom has that is so eye-popping here.
Quick toss by Martin. And it's caught out to about midfield by Noah Jenkins. Gain of about five. That's one thing that Highland Springs needs is some first down success. They've really struggled on first down here in this game.
Freedom's putting on a show right now. First quarter, they had 155 yards to Highland Springs' 21. Now the Springers changing up the tempo. We talked about establishing the tempo early. Now they have to go a little faster knowing the situation down by 28.
Martin back to pass. Throws it across the middle. He's got a man caught out in the open. That's going to be six. Jenkins to the house. Touchdown, Springers.
That's one way to respond. Go to the air game, and you see this Highland Springs team. They have pride not just on defense but on offense. Over the middle, little post there. Safety doesn't pick him up, and you have two guys running post there. You have Lovelace on the left side. On the right side, Noah Jenkins, the future Hokie, Virginia Tech commit. He can do some things on offense to go with his stellar work on defense. Springers back in this one potentially with that TD to get on the board.
little momentum here for Highland Springs. Here's the extra point, and it's up. And it's no good. Off to the right. So it'll stay 28-6. The home side here came to life on that touchdown. And maybe that will spur some defense that will stop this.
Remember, Andy,
freedom
we watched.
We'll see.
Yeah, remember we watched back in 2019 at Hampton University. Morey got up 28-0 on Stonebridge, and the Bulldogs were able to slowly but surely ease their way back into the game where it was 28-21 by the end of the third quarter. I'm not saying here, I'm not forecasting that the Springers necessarily do that, but there are two halves to a football game, and if they can get to halftime with this thing within two scores, two possessions, you have to feel like it's a plus that you've done something, considering Freedom was well on its way to another easy, yawning victory like they've had time and time again these last 2 years.
Well, a quick strike. And you never know, right, Matt? You just said it.
Gives you a chance, and that's the big thing. I can tell you, 29 seconds before halftime in the Class 2 final, Andy, Radford 25, Riverheads 14. So the Bobcats trying to keep the Gladiators of Riverheads from winning their eighth consecutive state championship and their first at the Class 2 level after dominating the Class 1 level for the past 7 years. Elon's getting a good one in Landon Clark, by the way. He's committed there and leading that Radford offense.
That ball hit an Eagle on the onside. Luckily for Freedom, they were able to grab a hold of it. Good kick right there. That would have been big.
Well, you know, not too many teams have tried onside kicks against Freedom because you have to score generally to kick off a lot of times, unless it's to begin the game or begin the second half. And see if they'll catch them napping. Now it's up to the Springers defense here with Freedom getting pretty decent field position at their own 43 with 7:49 to go until halftime. Quite sure the Highland Springs offense is going to diagnose where Jeff Overton is and make sure that they do something about him, not let him run free.
First and 10 for the Eagles at the 44. Overton tackled and dropped backwards.
Great defense here in pursuit. Once again, we see Brennan Johnson and a couple other black shirts on the defense for Highland Springs getting to Overton to bring him down. Number 24 also been on that stop to go with Johnson. Kasim Drumgoal, senior linebacker we've called out quite a bit. Sets up about 2nd and 8, maybe 2nd and 9 here for the Eagles.
Here's Evans under pressure. He's going to throw it away. Springer's brought some... Watch some pressure there.
It's not going to be intentional grounding. I know the Springer sideline is wanting that, but that's what you have to do. You've got to hit Evans as he throws. And by the way, a lot of time here in this second quarter to go, 7:05, and we've not seen Evans have to drop back and throw a ton here. Here's a key situation for him, potential to throw it on 3rd and about, call it 8 or 9 yards. Let's see how the Springers play this one with their coverage.
Overton. In motion, quick toss. Springers are all over it, and they're going to stuff them back behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be 4th and 11, and they'll get the ball right back.
You know, Andy, I think the Highland Springs football team knows the tongue lashing that was coming from Lauren Johnson at halftime. They want to make this thing more competitive, more respectable by intermission. And now Freedom, you wonder how they're going to deal with this as the comeback is beginning to happen. They had a similar situation against Verina, another Capital District team from the Richmond area in game 2. Had a big lead. Blue Devils made it interesting late. And they had to hold them off 35-27. They don't want deja vu. They want to cruise to victory here.
Punt picked up by Henley. He's got some run room. Look out. He's off to the races. Henley to the 30. 20. 10. Touchdown, Springer!
Oh, my.
Oh, wow. What a run. Penalty flags down.
Just the second punt of the day and sixth of the year for Freedom. It takes a hop. Reed doesn't down it. Henley picks it up. He goes about 72 yards.
Great move at the end here because Reed was back. And he just cuts in and says, not today, you're catching me. Henley with a huge play. Both penalties. The touchdown is good. Looks like both penalties against Freedom, so that will stand. What a run.
Ja'Kyrie Henley has done this before, and he had a 75-yard kickoff return for a touchdown this year, and the Springers as a team. They've scored special teams touchdowns now six times, I think it is, five or six times this year, and you're back in the ballgame here.
Extra point attempt. It's up, and it's good. So with 6:05 to go in the first half, all of a sudden, we got a ball game, and you can see the Springer fans coming to their feet. Watch this return one more time. Henley made it look like he wasn't going to take the ball. The defender there for Freedom ran past it. He just grabs it, says, okay, here we go. And look at the amount of teammates he's got in front of him. He's got a whole convoy taking him to the house. What a big play right there.
That's a game-changing play potentially. And if you're Darryl Overton, you're a little mad right now because you have some savvy football players that know you have to watch the ball and you can't let the guy pick it up and just dart off. You have the speed and the talent to catch anybody there. And I think that's a breakdown on special teams that they cannot afford here because another one can make this thing where the outcome's in jeopardy.
Well, you always talk about the championship games and how they always go back and forth with momentum. You got to weather the storm, as they say, right? Both of these teams have done that plenty over the last several years. Kick will be fielded back at the 4-yard line in a reverse. Look out. Running room to the sideline. And Reed, check that, looked like Courtney was knocked out of bounds at the 18.
And that's where I like the reverse better if you're on the wide side of the field. Anyway, they reversed it there with not a lot of room. And now Freedom is stuck with bad field position, up by 15, which ordinarily with 5:57 to go in the first half of a state championship game, you're saying, all right, I'll take that. And they're going to be backed up even further with a penalty on the return here. So some penalties which hurt them early on. They weathered that, got through it thanks to Overton's brilliance, the defense making a big play with Ja'Kai Jackson Hughes' pick six, also a pass breakup by him on fourth down when the Springers had it on their side of the 50. And now suddenly this Freedom offense has to put together a nice drive before giving it back to Highland Springs to add to the momentum as we approach halftime.
So Freedom trying to answer. And they'll go right to Overton, who's tackled in the backfield. And this Highland Springs defense all of a sudden looks like the Baltimore Ravens defense of 2000.
Is Brennan Johnson Ray Lewis?
You got to say so. Absolutely.
Question is, who can get that takeaway? They need a takeaway. They got the special teams play. Who can be that Ed Reed back there that can generate an interception? But second and 11 now. Evans has to show some poise here back here.
Quick toss, caught in the slot, out to about the 16.
Cam Courtney with a little head nod after he makes the catch and gets hit here. We're seeing this Highland Springs defensive backfield now answer the call here as you watch Ezekiel Burchett. We called him out earlier in the first quarter. Make the big hit on Courtney, the Indiana commit. Third and a few here. This is an awful big down if you're an Eagles fan and the Springers fans in black and gold on their feet here at Scott Stadium.
Evans on third down. He hands it off. It looks like it's going to be a first down run for Overton up the middle to the 22-yard line.
Again, we've talked about him between the tackles being a different type of runner this season. Now Freedom has, I wouldn't say a dilemma, but a decision to make. Do you want to go with some more tempo here with 4 minutes and change to go in the half? Score quickly. You could give the ball back to the Springers or end the half here with maybe the last possession.
Another quick toss out to the edge. Nowhere to go that time. Caught by Reed, and he's knocked backwards immediately. It'll be second and 10.
That's George Lovelace, and I think he's getting more run in the secondary today, Andy. He's usually a backup defensive back, starting wide receiver, but we talked about Braxton. I don't think he's available for them. So joining Devin Simmons and DeMontez Bullock Coles and Jamon Lewis along with Burchett.
Motion man, here's Evans. He hands it off to Overton up the middle, still fighting for extra yardage out to the 27.
Really using the running game up the middle here. We just wonder at what point does Overton bounce one. With third and three here, it could be a opportune time to see if he can dart off and get some separation.
Evans will hand it off. Overton, free again, gets hit hard in the secondary, but a first down run out to the 39.
Tell you what, he runs with more of a ferocity to him this year. 5'11", 185 pounds. He's just trampling over defenders. Running with a purpose and a passion. Looking to silence that Highland Springs crowd here that's decked out in all kinds of black and gold here at UVA.
Here's Evans looking for it down the sideline. Almost a one-handed grab by Preston, but it's incomplete. Had him open. They ran two verticals up the right side of the field there. And he caught him in the right coverage there, Matt. Nobody around Preston.
Nobody. And again, this Highland Springs secondary playing off the receivers, giving them a bit of a cushion, a nice 4 to 5 yard cushion. Now we'll watch on the far side here. Looks like it's going to be Lovelace playing tighter on Preston. And I think we'll see a timeout called.
2:44 to play here in this first half. It looked like a blowout. And all of a sudden, it looks like a ball game. Carry by Overton. Past the 40, out to the 45.
That's an effective run there as they handed it off to Overton to make it third and short here. Keep an eye on Evans in the pocket. He could scramble as well.
Quick toss, caught, 49-yard line on third down. It's going to be shy of the first down marker. Good catch by Aaron Duncan, but not enough. Well, they say it is enough. How about that?
I thought he was short, Andy, but Noah Jenkins just absolutely unloaded on him. He drilled him on that catch, and Duncan playing tight end. He's the one that caught the record-breaking TD pass from Evans last week in that state semifinal win over Madison. They can flex him out. He's a tight end with versatility. It's sort of that new-age tight end where you can almost move him out to a receiver spot.
First and 10. Evans hands it off to Overton. Right side. Gain of a couple. I thought he was short. I thought that was at least a measurement.
I thought for sure it'd be a measurement, and then they did not. Which I'm a little surprised Lauren Johnson in the sideline didn't show a little more emotion about that decision. And now his defense has to lock in here with a minute and a half as the time's ticking down. They want to make Freedom have to try a field goal, keep them to these small chunks.
A
Penalty flag flies. It's going to be a false start.
Well, we talked about it, Andy. Three penalties for 28 yards in the first quarter for the Eagles. None on the Springers. So Highland Springs has played a pretty disciplined football game to this point. They did have the interception that hurt them. A couple of missed chances on fourth downs. One on the other side of the 50 in Freedom territory. The other on a fourth and short, just shy of midfield. And I think we did get a timeout call as Lauren Johnson speaking with one of the referees about something on the near side here. It's an official's timeout. Now they're going to signal for play to resume here. The clock keeps ticking for Freedom. They're not in any hurry here, Andy, as we tick near a minute to go in the half.
28-13, still a sizable lead. Quick toss out to Preston. He's got it, still on his feet. Check that read, and he goes backwards behind midfield. They're giving forward progress right at the midfield stripe. That'll be no gain for E.J. Reed.
You know, against most teams, he turns that simple screener hitch into a 40-yarder. But against Highland Springs, they have enough athletes and speed on the field to neutralize that. You can't really reverse the other way against this team and have it pay off.
Pass and catch out there. Courtney will take it about a yard shy of the first down. It'll be fourth down and about a yard here for Freedom.
Really like his game. He's been smooth so far in his first half. Most teams, he's the number one target. I think on this team, he's third in receiving with 46 grabs for 685 yards and 11 TDs coming in.
Evans in the shotgun now. Motion man. Hands it off. Overton stopped at the line of scrimmage, and it's going to be Springer football.
Look who
great
was it
defense.
On the stop. Number 11 again, Brennan Johnson, a.k.a. Peanut. We watch it again. Comes through from the linebacker spot. Read and react. He's so smart out there. He gets to him before anybody does and drags him down.
Great pursuit by the Springers in the middle of that defense. And they've got a shot here, but not much time left on the clock. 17 seconds. The last time they threw a pass, it probably took about 8 seconds.
Yeah, they can strike quickly here. And I don't know that Lauren Johnson is thinking about field goal necessarily. They've tried a couple this year, one by Jarrell Dent, one by J.R. Anderson, and they both were good.
There's Martin throwing it up for Henley. It's going to be picked off back at the 20. And that'll give it right back to Freedom with 7 seconds on the clock there. That was Cameron Courtney on the interception.
Fourth INT of the year for the Indiana Hoosiers commit. We just talked about how smooth he is on offense, and that one was just overthrown over the head of Henley. He had no chance at that one. And it's like a punt, though, Andy, with 7 seconds to go. It doesn't hurt you, but, you know, Highland Springs got its job done on that last series defensively to keep this thing at a two-possession game. Now the question is that first drive in the third quarter. That sets really the stage for the remainder of the ball game, and I keep coming back to it. It reminds me a lot of that 2019 title game with Maury and Stonebridge, where Maury raced out to the 28-point lead. Stonebridge scored 21 unanswered, and the Maury defense had to buckle down late to hold them off.
Well, the defense for Highland Springs has settled in some. I say that. They did give up a 72-yard run, you know, not too long ago, but in the last couple drives, they've been tougher against the run.
Consider it was by the superhuman Jeffrey Overton.
Right.
So
Freedom takes a knee, and that'll take us to the half. 28-13. Don't go anywhere. It might be an instant classic down the back stretch. We'll be back after these words. Oh.
High school sports fans, relive your favorite moments. Just click the shopping cart below the video player to get your digital copy today. High school sports fans, relive your favorite moments. Just click the shopping cart below the video player to get your digital copy today. This presentation of the NFHS Network is brought to you by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Have fun out there.
With great brands at the best prices at Academy Sports and Outdoors, you'll always find more fun. More of this and this. And more of this and this. So you can do more of that. And that. And that. And definitely some of that. While getting together for more of that, that, and that. Yes! Have more fun with great brands at the best prices, only at Academy Sports and Outdoors.
High school sports fans, relive your favorite moments. Just click the shopping cart below the video player to get your digital copy today. High school sports fans, relive your favorite moments. Just click the shopping cart below the video player to get your digital copy today.
This presentation of the NFHS Network is brought to you by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Have fun out there.
With great brands at the best prices at Academy Sports and Outdoors, you'll always find more fun. More of this and this. And more of this and this. So you can do more of that. And that. And that. And definitely some of that. While getting together for more of that. That. And that. Yes! Have more fun with great brands at the best prices. Only at Academy Sports and Outdoors.
High school sports fans, relive your favorite moments. Just click the shopping cart below the video player to get your digital copy today. High school sports fans, relive your favorite moments. Just click the shopping cart below the video player to get your digital copy today. This presentation of the NFHS Network is brought to you by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Have fun out there.
With great brands at the best prices at Academy Sports and Outdoors, you'll always find more fun. More of this and this. And more of this and this. So you can do more of that. And that. And that. And definitely some of that. While getting together for more of that, that, and that. Yes! Have more fun with great brands at the best prices, only at Academy Sports and Outdoors.
High school sports fans, relive your favorite moments. Just click the shopping cart below the video player to get your digital copy today. High school sports fans, relive your favorite moments. Just click the shopping cart below the video player to get your digital copy today.
And we welcome you back here at the half of the 2023 VHSL Class 6 Football State Championship. The Highland Springs Springers trailing 28-13 to the defending 6A state champion, Freedom Eagles. We welcome you back here in the booth, Andy Hayes alongside Jack Hayes. Good to have you with us here today. Hope you're enjoying our coverage back home. Jack, the storyline in the first half, Jeff Overton. Not really a shocker. We said you had to watch number six.
Well, there's no doubt about that. Jeff Overton in the first half running for 164 yards with as long as the 72. We saw his long 72-yard run hurtling over a defender. I'd say that puts him over 1,000 rushing yards for the playoffs alone. That's a pretty that's a pretty scary stat there for Jeffrey Overton. But then talking about the quarterback here, Evans, and, you know, we're going to highlight his ability to hit the short throws, you know, like the screens, the slants across the middle, the five-yard throws.
And the
runs. His ability to run.
Yeah. It kind of sets up these kind of plays right here. There you see Cameron Courtney with a nice touchdown run. That got Freedom on the board. But the whole offense works when Evans is doing his thing. And I think Highland Springs kind of got onto that a little bit toward the end of the first half. What do you think?
Right. No, there's no doubt about that. Freedom putting up the early 28 points. And then Highland Springs having to find an answer. And their defense is stepping up in a big way. Obviously, the Overton run, you know, was one thing that we're going to highlight. But the Highland Springs has been pretty dominant in the last, you know, 6 to 8 minutes of the second quarter. So we'll see if they can come out strong in the second half and keep Freedom, you know, with very minimal points to get their offense back in this game for them.
You saw Ja'Kai Jackson-Hughes on that interception return for a touchdown. That was the second score for Freedom. Highland Springs had some good field position. They just couldn't do much with it. And then Evans with a big run here kind of got Freedom back out towards midfield. First quarter seemed like it lasted forever. And then you saw Overton do what he does. And once he gets out in the open, he's pretty tough to bring down. I think the highlight run, even though this was going to be one that we watched a couple times, he bounces there off to the right and he's off to the races. The highlight run maybe of the entire day could be this run we're going to watch in the second quarter with Overton. That play, Jack, was a 4th-and-1 from the 29-yard line. So if Highland Springs can stop him there, I mean, you got a chance, right? They're right there off of a couple good defensive plays. And the bottom line is on 4th-and-1. Watch this play here. Overton to the near side, gets a great block out front. And then watch this hurdle right here. And takes the defender, jumps over the top of him, and he's off to the races. Those are the kind of plays that change ball games. The two-point conversion to the right side was good, and it's 28-0. At that point, Jack, we thought game over, right?
Right.
Very next drive, Christian Martin finds a wide-open Noah Jenkins for a touchdown on the second play of that drive, and boom, Highland Springs with some momentum. The missed extra point happens, almost an onside kick that looked pretty strong, but Freedom comes back out, and they go 3-and-out right away. And Highland Springs gets the ball back. And on the punt return, our guy that we like to talk about, Kyrie Henry here, 5'9", 175-pound senior, picks it up out of nowhere. Watch him go. And look at the host of teammates he has in front of him. A whole blockade up there to help get him to the end zone. And Henley pulls Highland Springs back from 28-6 to 28-13. And that's where we ended the first half of action. Freedom with a couple chances to add to it. But Highland Springs on defense, pretty stout there. It was Johnson from the linebacker position doing his job. And this was the last play
of the first half for Highland Springs on offense. It was an interception. Didn't do any damage, and that sent us here to the half. So thoughts for the second half. How do you expect it to go?
Well, if you remember last year when Highland Springs was playing Stonebridge in the state championship last year. Semifinals. Christian Martin started to use his legs and run more. We haven't seen him run for very much. We've seen him rush for 6 yards right in the first half. So I'm kind of expecting Christian Martin to start using his legs. And, you know, then once you use your legs more, it might keep the Freedom defense off balance and you can throw some home runs down the field.
Yeah, we'll see if that happens here in the second half. We'll send you away for a quick break. As we send you back out to the field, our halftime score, 28-13. We're getting ready for the action right after this. Back to the action here. Start of the third quarter. Andy Hayes, Matt Hatfield, Jack Hayes with you. I hope you're enjoying our coverage back home live from Scott Stadium on the campus of UVA. So Highland Springs will kick it to start the second half. It'll be a pooch kick that's going to land out of bounds at the 28-yard line. So Freedom will get pretty good field position. Matt, we gave the chair to the young guy here. He said a couple things about Christian Martin in the second half, that Christian Martin needs to run the football a little bit more to open up that defense some of Freedom. Your thoughts on that?
I totally agree, and I also want to see if Lauren Johnson goes to some of that option run game that they've shown earlier in the playoffs, particularly in that round three win over Manchester. As we'll see with decent field position looks like they're going to re-kick this thing. But in Freedom's case, you know, you look at some of the first half numbers, and Jeff Overton has been a machine, 163 yards passing. Tristan Evans has 10 completions, Andy, for 41 yards. That's less than 5 yards a completion. And you look at what he's done this year, I mean, he's put up staggering numbers, but he usually averages about 17 to 18 yards per completion. So big difference. The Highland Springs defense has given him the underneath things. They're not letting him go over the top. And what is the counter for Freedom? Are they going to stay patient with their offense and avoid the penalties that have plagued them so far in this first half? 5 flags for 42 yards, none for the Springers.
So we'll kick it again here to start the second half. Saw some of those highlights in that first half. That run by Overton was just silly. Low kick. Going to be fielded by Reed back at the 10-yard line. Got some running room past the 40, 45, 50. And knocked out of bounds there, but a penalty flag down. Looks like a hold from our view up here against Freedom.
Yeah, I think this one's coming back as we watch the kickoff and the replay again here. You'll see right here on your screen about the 35-yard line. Looks like they got a lot of jersey and he let go of it on number 5 and the flag was flying by then. One of those, I didn't do it. I didn't do it. You didn't catch me.
That's always a good indicator.
Yeah.
Holding call, it'll move it back to the 28. So it'll be first and 10 for the Eagles. We kind of feel like the defense needs to come up with a big turnover here, maybe a pick six of their own, something for Highland Springs to really put some pressure on Freedom in this third quarter.
Yeah, and we saw early in the game the Highland Springs defense get that pick six from Chikai Jackson-Hughes. Springers would love to get a fumble recovery or something of that nature.
Run to the left, nowhere to go. Loss of a yard there for Overton. Or check that Reed, he's back at the 26 now, so almost 2 yards. They give him forward progress to the 27.
Now, Overton ran the ball, Andy, 16 times in that first half. Who's going to be that complimentary rushing threat? You know, Tristan Evans had a couple of the long runs, but this is where they need to diversify the attack to a degree.
There's the give to Overton. He's got some running room. Oh, what a move. And he's out past the 35 to the 36, a yard shy of the first down. Those little moves right there, a little cut right there, is what gets everybody excited about him, because if you miss him, he's gone. Watch his right, boom, right there. Yeah. I mean, that's special stuff.
He lets the play develop, and he's got that acceleration and burst too when he gets to that second and third level. The thing you do wonder about in this game is keeping him fresh, because he does go both ways. So fourth quarter, if they need him to run and get the hard yards, got to keep that stamina there. There's a nice extension to get to first down on third and short for the Eagles. And that time they go to that secondary rushing option, the complimentary piece, and Cam Courtney, who's doing a little bit of everything today, offense, defense, special teams too. Big way to knife his way forward up to the 41-yard line for the first down.
That moves the chains. Freedom comes out. Overton in the back to the right of Evans. Check that. It is Overton. Check that Courtney's running the football. I thought that might be him. Out to midfield.
Well, I think some of that, Andy's what we talked about. It's going back to keeping Overton fresh, because he does have to carry the ball so much. And now you wondered about that Highland Springs defensive backfield. No Tamondre Braxton today. There is a flag on the play, though. Let's see what in this preliminary signal seems to be. It's coming back on the Eagles as they're moving backwards past the inside their own portion of the field before the 50.
See who it's on. A couple players mixing it up way off the ball. They were out of the shot completely. There's a holding call against Highland Springs and a unsportsmanlike call against Freedom. So they're going to take it forward for the holding call and then backward for a dead ball call. At the conclusion of this ball game, Matt and I will name the Academy Sports and Outdoors Player of the Game. And I would say right now, number 6 for Freedom is leading the charge. 164 yards at the half and 2 touchdowns. But who knows? You never know how it's going to play out. So get that on your radar. The Academy Sports and Outdoors Player of the Game at the conclusion of this one.
Yeah, whole other half of football here. Well, we should say 9:55 left in this quarter, and then a fourth period to decide who gets that. And these two programs wanting to repeat as state champs. Freedom did it in Class 6 last year. Highland Springs moving up from Class 5. So many storylines that we're following in this ball game, and what a turnout. What a day of weather, Andy. We've had some snow in state championships, some rain, wind, cold. This is as good a day weather-wise as we could have asked for in Charlottesville here for the state finals.
Trying to figure out, it's going to be first down and about 7 here for Freedom. You're right, Matt. Now, I know you remember this. We did a state championship broadcast in pouring rain.
Yeah.
Remember that? Centerville won the state championship against Oscar Smith in a downpour that
2011,
year.
If I remember right. Yeah.
Might have been 13.
13, yes.
13. They did play. Yep, they played Ocean Lakes in 11.
Yep.
But Centerville's 2013 team was 15-0, and they beat a really good Oscar Smith team.
Yes.
You know, we go back and forth between, Northern Virginia, 757.
Absolutely.
You and I have that battle going.
We can argue about that next game.
Yeah.
Another movement again. And I remember the 2008 at Virginia Tech, the snow falling. That was a memorable one as well.
Oscar Smith winning their first state title with Rich Morgan in 08.
I think your game before that was Phoebus Dinwiddie. Adam Morgan and the Generals against Taj Boyd and the Phantoms.
Incredible.
Yeah.
And it was snowing. Oscar Smith, I think, played Osborne. Is that right? Osborne?
They did. Yeah. You know what's so awesome about the NFHS Network, Andy, is people can always go back, if they have time, watch some of these awesome championship games on demand.
No doubt about it. There's Overton. He'll keep it. Bouncing to the left. And he's going to get back, plus a couple from the original line of scrimmage after that false start penalty.
You brought it up earlier. His added strength has made him a more dangerous runner this year than a season ago when he was a really good one as a 10th grader, a pup at the time, who got Class 6 State Offensive Player of the Year. And that turns what was ordinarily a negative play, you would think, for a lot of backs and offenses, into a second and manageable for their team here, and now the receivers can be back in the flow here. They can use a lot of different things in the playbook to try to extend this possession.
We're not seeing Evans in the ball game. I wonder if he's hurt.
I haven't seen him get dinged up yet.
Overton's going to throw it down the sideline.
Oh, what a catch! Preston, touchdown, Freedom! Wow, one-handed grab. Unbelievable from Jeff Overton, who's not even a quarterback. Watch this.
I think it's actually, was that Overton?
That's
that was
Overton.
Overton. Yeah, wow.
Look at this catch.
One-handed with the left hand.
Come on. Incredible. It's going to be a pass interference call in Highland Springs. Carlton Preston. Remember the name.
Ooh, Juju.
Unbelievable. We'll watch that one more time after the extra point. That was absurd. I don't know if I've ever seen something like that. Number one, you got your tailback throwing the ball with gloves on. He throws a wobbly pass. Sorry, Jeff. Wasn't the prettiest spiral. And we do compliment you a lot, so don't get upset. But that was perfect. And Preston just tapped it up to himself with one arm because bottom line is the other one was being held. We'll go back and watch it one more time. Unbelievable. I think he's going to overthrow him by 5 yards here, and he just turns on the burner.
Yeah.
Speed
for days.
Play, man.
Speed for days. That is a different breed right there. And you see why Clemson, and you even see some of the people in the background just nodding
nice
like,
catch,
yeah,
nice
he's not bad. He's going to play on Saturdays.
Yes. I can't keep track of all these guys going to college. Where's he heading to college?
Clemson, he's a
Clemson.
Junior. Yeah. Just a junior. He's another year. You got him and Overton coming back next year.
Coach Dabo Swinney's watching that highlight going, yeah, buddy.
Yeah.
Clemson Nation, let's go. The Tigers are going to love number one. What a catch.
Well, I think he was a little jealous of his teammates. He wanted in on the act. That was a sensational play. And a guy who, coming into this game, was putting up monster numbers. We talked about the 65 catches for 12, 29, and 18 TDs.
Here's the kick. Low kick. It's going to be picked up at about the 17 by Bird. Bird's got some running room. Back up the field to about the 37. Just for fun, one more time. I feel like that's one of the greatest plays we've ever seen. And Clemson fans will want to watch this. Coach Swinney will want to watch this. Here's Carlton Preston with the one-handed grab for the touchdown from Jeff Overton, the tailback. How can you not be excited about number one if you're a Clemson fan? Whew.
That's highlight reel material. That's if you're doing your highlight tape, Juju, and you watch this later, you put that at the front of the highlight tape. Don't let that save for the back end. Put that on the front end. Jack, you would use that as your first play if you did that, right?
There's no doubt about
that.
Yeah, there's no
already
doubt
been
that.
Sent out on social
media. No doubt. Yeah. No doubt.
So Highland Springs down 35-13. Got to climb back in it. They definitely did not need that kind of play to happen. Here's a pass from Martin.
Highland Springs, how do you respond from that? That can be a sucker punch. You know, that it's hard to get off the mat from something like that. When you think you've got him stopped, and it wasn't like the coverage was all that terrible,
no,
but he gets by him.
It was going to be a pass interference based on the hold of the right hand of Preston. But in reality, he was right there. The defensive back was right there.
And now Highland Springs has got a third and short to try to convert. I understand Radford is up 32-21 on Riverheads, Andy, with 9:04 to go as the Bobcats just stopped Caden Cook Cash and the Gladiators on 4th-and-1. So could have a storyline play out there where Michael Christ, the head coach at Radford, wins his first state championship at Radford. You know, his father, David Crist, won a state championship, a couple of them, at Blacksburg High School. I don't know any father's sons that have won state championships before in VHSL football. If anybody out there knows, let us know. It could be the first time that's happened.
As coaches? Or
yeah,
players?
As head coaches.
Yeah, you're right about that. I know we've got injury time out here. Looks like Javier Frazier is the injured Springer. Well, you've got not his head coaches, but Mickey Thompson and his sons coach
sure.
together.
Yeah.
But you're right about that.
History could be made there out there in Salem today. It will be made in either way because Radford's trying to win a state title and Riverheads has won 7 in a row. I understand the Phoebus-Salem game was a 1-point game, I believe, at halftime. 7-6 still in the third quarter there. So a defensive grudge match. And we've had a lot of offensive fireworks in this game.
Martin back to pass to Jenkins. Caught at the 50. Tries to spin out of the tackle. Can't do it. But he does get the first down on third down. Big conversion there. So that'll move the chains.
That's a stop route, simple play there. You catch it, move along with its drive here if you're Highland Springs and try to stay in the ring toe-to-toe with this freedom attack that will end this season, Andy, whether they win or lose this ballgame. Every contest is here 35-plus points for the second year in a row.
Option play, and that one cut down immediately by guess who? Number 7, Ja'Kai Jackson Hughes.
Another junior, by the way. This 2025 class for Freedom is loaded. He comes on the perimeter and just takes him down right away on the pitch. It's going to be on Highland Springs here, so a negative situation either way you slice it for Lauren Johnson Springers.
Penalty flag down. Looks like it's going to be against Highland Springs. They're going to say move them back. Make it a longer first down coming up.
Well, you don't have to get it all back in one play for Highland Springs here. You have to stay very, very deliberate in your approach here. I don't think you get out of character.
So it's going to be first and 25. First and 25. Let's go, Bird to the left of Martin here, way back now at the 35. They'll run the option. This could be a quarterback keeper. And it's almost like they listened to Jack's comments about running Christian Martin here at halftime. That's what they're doing here, but gain of about 5. Not a bad gain. It's second down and 20.
Well, and to Highland Springs' credit, they only had that one penalty here in this quarter. They hadn't been penalized at all in the first half. More of their adjustments are going to be made defensively against this freedom attack. And Martin trying to overcome a couple of picks here. He's not been as crisp throwing the football, so a lot hinges on the running attack.
Going to throw this one up in the air. That's going to be a penalty flag. Right call there. It looked like George Loveless was being held. And that was actually a good throw by Martin. He gave him a chance to go get it. E.J. Reed, the defensive back here, and you can kind of see him grabbing that right arm.
It's a tough matchup one-on-one for the 5'9" E.J. Reed against Lovelace, who checks in at 6'2", so he's got a size advantage. And maybe those are the throws you throw if you're Martin, where only he can go get it if you throw it over top or the jump ball's closer to you as opposed to in traffic over the middle.
So second down And we'll call it four here now. Still not a first down because of how far away they were on that last play. Here's a quick toss. Uh-oh, Jenkins has it knocked up in the air, incomplete. Big hit. Jeff Overton saying, hey, that was a fumble. Let's watch that one again. That was a great hit after the catch.
Big time.
And I believe it was Overton who got him. Yeah, it was. I don't know. That looked like he was running with it there, Matt. I can see
it
why
did.
Overton had a thought about that, but there's no replay. In
yeah, you can't throw a challenge flag. No challenge flags out here.
Just for fun, you know, that's one of those, did he have a continuation of the play, right? Isn't that what they all say all the time when we're watching the NFL Sunday?
Well, and with more technology, do you see, I wouldn't have asked this question 10 years ago, do you see the day coming where maybe that could be implemented for something like a state championship game, a replay? For, I mean, not all the entire season, but for
did
a championship
Did you see the
game?
West Virginia state championship where the kid makes the catch, one-handed catch, maybe the greatest catch I've seen in a long time.
Sure.
Other than the one we just saw.
Yeah.
But touchdown in the corner, one-handed grab, foots down. They call it incomplete, but West Virginia instituted replay.
So they did.
And they overturned it.
That's good. I would like to see it. I asked a basketball referee. We'll talk about it in second, third, and five here.
Quick toss to Henley, and he's got the first down to the 36, 35-yard line of freedom. Yeah, I mean, you know, you think about it. If we have replay and the folks at home are looking at it, how hard would it be to have a crew from the VHSL officiating crew come down here and just look at it
sure. And
make a decision?
I asked a basketball referee because we had that dunk in the Woodside Patrick Henry Roanoke Class 5 basketball championship that was good, or the layup at the end that won the game, if they would be in favor of it. And they said, sure, any technology to help them at the end of a game or certainly in a championship would be different than all year long with technology.
Here's Martin. And he's going to be tackled right at the line of scrimmage, 34-yard line.
Good job collapsing the pocket by Jewel Harris there. You see why he was defensive player of the year. He's working inside out here, sometimes outside in, as he's able to just keep Martin, take away those lanes he's got to run with the football, because he has been such a weapon for Highland Springs this year, running the football, coming in with 346 yards rushing and 6 TDs, which includes sometimes he's been sacked and had to lose some yards, so he could easily be at over 500-plus as the trigger man.
Martin in the shotgun. Under 5 to play here, third quarter. Toss to Jenkins, that one dropped. Courtney was standing right there. Probably wouldn't have been a big game, but nonetheless, it would have made it a manageable third down. It'll be third down and almost 10 now for Highland Springs. And they're in four down territory. I mean, it's a huge drive. They need to try to get this thing back within 15 points if they can.
They have to score here to give themselves a shot when the fourth quarter begins, and a field goal is not going to cut it with this Freedom team. They'll let you get 3 all day long because they know they can get 7.
Quick throw to the edge. It's going to be short of the first down, though. Loveless trying to spin out of the tackle. Couldn't get free, and so here we go, 4th and 1.
And on the outside there, they're getting those underneath throws, but they're going shotgun again, surprisingly, as opposed to under center for 4th and 1. I think it makes it harder to get a gain if the quarterback has to take off and run here.
They try to run the option, maybe a quarterback power run to the right. Nope, he's going to drop back the pass. Throws it towards the end zone for Henley. Touchdown! What a catch. What a throw. Carly Henry. 4th and 1 for 6.
I see some rain starting to fall here in Charlottesville, and that time Springers go up top. Henley from Martin, TD strike, and they're back in this thing to make it a 2-possession game as the future Terp delivers a bullet for a TD.
Tremendous catch by Henley. An even better throw by Martin. The extra point is up, and it's good. And Highland Springs is hanging in there. We'll watch that one more time. Again, 4th down and 1 here, and we think maybe they'll run it. Nope. Martin's going to go back to his man Henley to the end zone. Pretty good coverage, too. But Henley comes down with it. You see the excitement down on the sideline there. And the Springer Nation still with some hope. It's 35-20 now here in the third quarter.
We thought there'd be a lot of scoring in this game, Andy. I think this is on track to maybe be the highest state championship scoring game of the day. It's certainly going to be in position to if we see these two teams continue to trade punches as far as throwing the football down the field. And just when I was complimenting the nice weather we've got, I'm starting to see some of the rainfall and some fans get the umbrellas out, head for the concourse, if you will, as we're starting to see a little more rain come down here in Charlottesville.
Pooch kick, angling back to about the 29, a fair catch there. And that'll be where Freedom takes over.
Well, I'm back to work for the Freedom offense. They've been able to run it. They've been able to throw it. Juju Preston with that unbelievable one-handed snag. Overton's been everywhere. Cam Courtney, two, number five. Keep an eye on him for a reverse or a trick play. They like to get him. And Aaron Duncan threw, a TD pass this year. They have a lot of different weapons that can be involved, even if Tristan Evans, who's back out there now, we're wondering if he was hurt at quarterback, isn't the one delivering a throw.
Here's a give to Overton, and he's stuffed back in the backfield.
You know, it's easy to say outside of the long runs, the 40-yard scramble Evans had, the 72-yard hurdle my defender TD to the house, highlight reel play for Overton. The Springer's defense has held up against the run, but then you look at the stat sheet, you see 248 yards rushing on 22 attempts going to halftime. But the big thing about making these stops on first and second down is it puts Freedom where they need to have to throw it on either second or third to keep the drives going potentially.
Overton bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. It'll be third and long coming up.
Brings his defensive front starting to really hunker down and make this a battle.
Evans sacked. Fourth down coming up. Again, number 11, Brennan Johnson.
And they're rotating those guys in and out in the defensive line. Andy, Nick Jones, 52. Jaden Schiller, 57. They're not budging at all. They're getting off these blocks. They're shedding them well. They're getting to the quarterback. They're breaking things down. And now the Freedom offense here, you know, hasn't done a whole lot in this half. They scored 28 of those points literally in the game's first 16 minutes. So in the last, what are we talking about, 18 minutes of play? Just one big play, which was Preston's. He did what? Can you believe it? Touchdown catch. And if they stop him there, this is a one-score game, and the Springers are getting it back.
There's the punt. It's blocked. Rolling around, and Highland Springs will have it at the 20 of Freedom.
George Lovelace came through and blocked it.
Watch it right here. Unreal.
They don't punt a whole lot, Andy, so it's not something they work on as far as protecting against the punts, but when you make them punt, make them do something that they're uncomfortable doing, now you see how they react to it, and Highland Springs is scratching, clawing, fighting their way back in this title game at UVA.
Incredible couple minutes here as a timeout looks like is called by Freedom. And I think Coach Overton just wants to make sure his guys are calmed down. They still have a 15-point lead, Matt, but it doesn't feel like it right this second, does it?
No, it doesn't. All the momentum has swung completely. And it all happened with beginning that 74-yard punt return by Ja'Kyrie Henley that made it a two-score game late in our first half. Freedom marched down the field, didn't convert the fourth down. Springers got picked by Courtney at the end of the half, but here they are. They were able to respond with Henley again on the TD catch from Martin on fourth down. And Noah Jenkins, George Lovelace, and company have stepped up. You got Jenkins in the back end of the secondary covering some of these receivers. The run game has been neutralized by Brennan Johnson and company, and now Martin This opens up the whole package here in playbook with the running game and two backs in the backfield with Bird to his left and Hundley to his right.
Martin in the shotgun. Crucial opportunity here to cash in on. Handoff in the backfield. Going here to the left side. That appeared to be Hundley there. And he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of a yard. I mean, this is pivotal right here. You get the big block punt. You're on the 20. You got to score. You got to get back within one score, right?
But running wide on that Freedom defense is so hard to do. You got Ja'Kai Jackson-Hughes, Devin Reeves. They're all pinching down. And
Hundley's been the big play threat along with Jenkins. They're both split out to the near side on second down and 11.
They're tight on Lovelace up top.
Quick toss. Jenkins has got it. Running room. Back to the middle. Touchdown, Highland Springs. And here come the Springers.
Very simple, basic design, but they execute it flawlessly. Jenkins gets it a couple of blocks. He's got Bird and the lineman going down the field, including big 58 there, Raekwon Taylor. And Jenkins will scoot his way to pay dirt here with 1:17 to go in the third quarter. We've got ourselves a ball game. Highland Springs has won 5 state championships in the last 8 years for a reason. So much heart, pride, determination, not going down without a fight. And Andy, I think you asked me before the ball game what the score pick would be. 35-27 is what we've got, but we still got more football to play.
Unbelievable momentum shift here in Charlottesville. Highland Springs with an enormous block punt. George Lovelace does the honors there. You see that. And then the Springers, right away, they catch him in a blitz. And Noah Jenkins, with some blocking in front, takes it to the house for the touchdown. And it is now a one-score game, 35-27. Freedom still holding on. Still a third quarter too, Matt. A minute and 18.
That's why my prediction has still got a lot of time to go. I don't think it's going to be scoreless the rest of the way.
I think your prediction is going to
be out
the
window now. Yeah, it's way
Pooch out. Kick again. Fair caught at the 30.
But this is, if you like scoring, if you like big plays, this is the game for you here, because we have seen some huge shifts of momentum. We had that early interception from Ja'Kai Jackson-Hughes. Overton, the 72-yard TD run. Springers came back with the punt return from Hundley, the block punt you just watched. And then Christian Martin, he has really settled in here in the second half. He's throwing the football a lot better. He looks more composed. He has shook off the two interceptions early on in the first half. And Freedom's offense hasn't had to go to the air a whole lot. Do they do so on this drive? They might have to, because the running game has sort of been bottled up.
Agreed. First and 10, Evans in the shotgun. He's going to hand it back to Cameron Courtney, and he's going to find nowhere. And guess who? Brandon Johnson stopped that play immediately.
I think he heard you said it was going to be some players of the game named after this game, and he wants to be one of those. Watch Brennan Johnson. Diagnosis right away. He comes through. Nobody blocks him. And then afterwards, you see a little late block trying to get a little shove there. Number 53, Talia for Freedom, one of the senior linemen. But they're behind the sticks again. And Freedom is not used to operating with second and 11, third and 11, second and 12 situations. We'll put Courtney in motion here.
Quick toss to the edge. And Courtney will run over a Springer on the side. That was DeMontez Bullock-Coles who took the brunt of that hit, but it's still going to be third down and 6.
Andy, you don't think of an offense that set the VHSL single-season scoring record a year ago and is averaging 59.3 points per game, needing someone to come to the rescue. But here on third and 11, or check that, third and about, we'll call it third and 6, maybe 7, you need someone to come to the rescue. And Jeff Overton's been that guy time and time again. Tristan Evans has to really make a big play with his arm or feet here. And the Highland Springs defense, they're not letting him go down the field. They're playing in that same cover three type of look, making him have to be very patient.
There's Evans straight ahead, and he's short of the first down. He's at the 39. It's going to be fourth and one.
Do you go for it?
Oh, still 33 seconds and counting left third quarter.
I tell you what I would do. I would line up quickly here as the time is ticking down to see if you can get them to jump off sides and let the quarter run out. That's what I would do if I'm Freedom. I'm a little surprised they're not doing that here with 10 seconds to go. See if they'll jump potentially or line up properly. But the quarter will run out, and we'll go to the fourth with a lot of drama and excitement still in store.
My goodness. What a ball game. And we thought it might be over in the first quarter of action. Or were we wrong? Folks, don't go anywhere. We'll come back with quarter number four. We got a ball game for you.
This presentation of the NFHS Network is brought to you by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Have fun out there.
With great brands at the best prices at Academy Sports and Outdoors, you'll always find more fun. More of this and this. And more of this and this. So you can do more of that. And that. And that. And definitely some of that. While getting together for more of that. That. And that. Yes! Have more fun with great brands at the best prices. Only at Academy Sports and Outdoors.
Back to the action here. You're watching the 2023 VHSL Class 6 Football State Championship featuring the Freedom Eagles undefeated taking on Highland Springs at 13-1. 27 points now for Highland Springs. They trailed at one point in this game 28-0. They've made it a ball game. 4th-1, Freedom's going for it at their own 39. Jeff Overton, the deep back, and he's going to hand it off. Running room, what a move. Down to the 40 goes Cameron Courtney.
Courtney's upset he ran into the referee. If he doesn't run into the referee, he's probably off to the races. The referee inadvertently got in his way. We watch the replay again here, Andy. It's handed off to Courtney, and he just runs right into the referee, smack dab.
What a break for Highland Springs. And there's nothing you can do about that. It's just a referee trying to get out of the way. Overton will keep it now, and he's down to the 32. So they've taken Evans out, and there is a penalty flag down. It might be a holding call against Freedom. Matt, we haven't seen them do this a lot with Evans not being in the game. Maybe there's something wrong.
Well, you wonder about that, or is there something they saw late in the first half that made them uncomfortable, whether it be injury-related or how he's throwing the football? I mean, statistically speaking, he was fine, 10 of 14 for 41 yards, but he's not getting it down the field, so there could be some arm discomfort, something that's not allowing him to test them deep. But that time, you talk about the 12th man, the crowd being your advantage, and I think the Highland Springs crowd is being very loud here, giving them some energy to feed off of, and there was a 12th defender inadvertently that time on that run to play before.
Hard to beat 12.
It is.
I feel bad for the official. I'm sure he feels bad, too, that he was at the center of that play, but, you know, they're not quite as nimble out there as these running backs. It's hard to get away. Here's the carry. This one got some room again. Courtney down the sideline. 20, inside the 10, cuts it back. Touchdown, Freedom. And there's the answer right there.
Cam Courtney looked like he shot out of a cannon on that, and he just weaved his way for the last 10 to 15 yards again. They go to that Wildcat, hand it off. They knew right away when they handed it off that he was going to score this. I mean, the whole defense is just chasing him. There's one receiver blocking at the edge there. Good block delivered by Preston, and Cam Courtney made it look easy and effortless.
Unreal.
The Indiana commit.
The Hoosiers are getting a good one. Coach Signetti, the new coach, is going to like watching these highlights of number five here today. Here's the extra point, and the kick is up, and it's good. 11:33 to play, 42-27. But you just kind of feel like this one can't end without some drama. What do you think?
Well, and it could be the first to 50 in this game right now. The way they're scoring back and forth, trading blows. I mean, it has been something else here in this ball game. We had 28-13 at the break. It's now 42-27. And these two teams, they're used to scoring at a high rate. Does Highland Springs have enough weaponry and playmakers for this Freedom team? They certainly are showing the heart of a champion, the fight to come back in this thing. But Freedom just, if Overton's not doing it, they'll give it to Courtney. If he's not doing it, they'll go to Preston. So many different guys can step up and answer the call for Darrell Overton's Eagles from Woodbridge.
That was an impressive response right there. Much needed.
Look at the yardage, Andy, going into the fourth quarter, 379 to 160. You would not think this is a close ball game, but it is somehow because Highland Springs has made special teams special. Block punt, punt return, third phase has mattered.
Big plays, no doubt about it. Same thing true on the other side with Freedom. They've got a pick six today.
Yes.
And they also have an incredible one-handed grab, which not a special teams player, defensive play, but those kind of plays don't happen very often. They've been fortunate to have some of those things go well here today, and they are out front 42-27 as we see the kickoff go right back to about the 10-yard line, picked up by Simmons. Simmons got some running room, is going to get knocked out of bounds at about the 34. So that's where the Springers will start first down and 10. Again, any other game that starts out as a back and forth, Let's call it a one-score game at the half. You're sitting there going, hey, it could go either way. 28-0 in the first half. Freedom's out in front. To see Highland Springs fighting back, I'm not surprised. I know you aren't either. It's just they're a program full of champions. But here they are, and they really need a score here on this drive. They've got to get back within one with some time to make a stop, put some pressure on Freedom. A timeout called by the Eagles here. I want to remind you, our Academy Sports and Outdoors Player of the Game will be selected at the end of this one. Matt's got his statistics already in front of him. He's calculating like he does all the time, like the College Football Playoff Committee. They had all the numbers, right?
They did.
And they're still taking some heat.
Tie game, Phoebus and Salem with 58 seconds to go. The Spartans get a touchdown and two-point conversion to Josiah Moyer. So that one could be headed for extra fun at Liberty. 34-game winning streak for the Phantoms trying to get a three-peat. Salem with a 13-game winning streak. 10 state titles for the Spartans, 9 for the Phantoms. So you've got drama all across the NFHS network. This is where you need multiple accounts and multiple screens open at the same time to watch these games, right?
That's what I was just doing. I was just trying to figure out how to pull that up on my phone. Jack, pull the other game up on your phone, too. I mean, this is just a fun time. You're going to have some great games. Here we go, out of the timeout. Martin back to pass across the middle. Caught. Jenkins has got it. Past the 45 to the 47. That'll be a first down.
Really good, accurate throw by Martin. He stands in the pocket. He finds him on the inside route. They've had the post patterns there all day. Now, the Freedom secondary were complimenting earlier, but now having a little bit of a harder time against some of these, not even rub routes, but just routes in the middle of the field, although they are the safer routes on the outside because we did watch Martin get picked off earlier on one in the first quarter by Hughes.
First and 10, Martin back to pass, looking down the middle again. Got his man Henley. Oh, just a little bit too far to the inside. Henley was open.
Tell you what, Andy, I thought he was going to go to George Lovelace. He had him on a stop and go along the Freedom sideline, and it looked like he had a chance to loft that one down the field and test them deeper. It's weird to think this. You would anticipate that Freedom would take more shots vertically than Highland Springs, but we're watching the Springers use their passing game a lot more here in the second half than Freedom, which has really been content and leaned on the running game. Sometimes good, sometimes no success at all to it.
Second down and 10. Quick toss out to the edge. Caught. Lovelace has got it. And he's got a first down. Out to the 38. And that'll move the chains there for Highland Springs. I think one key point to bring up is the fact that Freedom's defensive line appears to be tired. And they were getting pressure on Martin in the first half. And you can see you got one of them down on his knee. I mean, they've been out there quite a bit because of the quick strike offense, right? I mean, you don't take a toll on that defense unless you're out there all the time. when they strike so quickly, man, you're playing a lot of minutes out there. Here's Martin. He's running the football. Oh. Oh. And that's going to be a big penalty. It'll go against number 10, Devin Reeves. We'll see what the call is. Martin appears to be okay.
Yeah, when you give yourself up like that with the slide, it's going to be called more times than not by the officials, and it's the right call. He slides down here, and then just to hit, you know, land the boom late there, too late for Reeves. And you're right, Andy, that these linemen are stuck in win for Freedom. We talked about it in the open about some of the guys that go both ways for Freedom, not just on the back end with Overton and Courtney, but on the front side of the defense. And now Highland Springs has wisely gone to up-tempo, playing with a faster rate of speed because they're behind two scores, and they know they can capitalize.
We don't have a targeting rule in high school football. And I'm not, there's no intent, I don't think, to hurt on that play, but that might have been a targeting call in the college game.
86-yard touchdown pass for Phoebus that might very well win the game with a freshman quarterback delivering that throw, and Maricus Banks.
Unreal. So first down and 10 for Highland Springs, just inside the 30-yard line. 9.5 to go. Martin's going to keep it, and he gets back to the line of scrimmage, and he's pulling Eagles with him down to the 26, a gain of 3. How did that even happen?
That is 1-2. That is, I don't want to go down to my final high school football game here in the rain.
Injury timeout. As a couple of the Eagles are slow to get up.
That was just a read option play where Bird just got demolished from the start. He decided to keep it last second, and he turned nothing or a loss into something that was, you know, a slight positive.
Not a good sign there as Preston was running off the field with his arm, his right arm not even moving. So clock moving. 8:51 and counting left here in this fourth quarter. Here's Martin, going to give it to Bird, and he runs right into a wall. It's going to be third down and about 6 here for Highland Springs.
The Highland Springs running game has not done a lot today. Through the three quarters that were played prior to this one, 28 yards on 13 attempts. So Eric Bird, who has been this workhorse back for Highland Springs, the Freedom defense, they've tackled him well.
And another timeout is going to have to be called by Freedom because they couldn't get the 12th man off the field in time.
I know with the physicality of this game picking up, these teams are glad this is the final game. They'll turn around and play someone next week because this has been a heavyweight bout.
Coaching staff for Freedom talking through all of the strategy here. They know that a touchdown for Highland Springs will make this one and that next drive interesting, to say the least. Matt, I thought you told me it was going to be sunny and 75 today.
It was so great until I said something, and all of a sudden the rain started coming out. Mother Nature said, I'll show you. Decided to mess with our lovely weather day we had. But it's not discouraging these fans from making a lot of noise and rooting their teams on to victory. And we've got another one after this one. Stonebridge and Maury should be a dandy as well.
Matt, that touchdown that you just talked about from Phoebus happened with 1 second left on the clock.
After the quarterback was sacked, I believe, right?
Unbelievable. What a way. And there's a big hit on third and 6.
Man, oh, man.
That one delivered by number 34, Braxton Hunt. He just introduced himself.
Yeah, I don't think we've called out his name all day, but Andy coming in, 71 tackles, 15 for loss, and hello, Mr. Bird. I'm here to play. How about you? Fourth down. Let's see what you got here, Springers, because you've been roaring back every time we've done something, and now Freedom's defense knows they get a stop here. It's going to move them one big step closer to back-to-back in another state championship.
So fourth down and 8 for Highland Springs. Man-to-man coverage at the top on Henley. Here's Martin. This one thrown in the flat, and it's incomplete. Bird, the intended receiver, he had the first down if he could have hauled it in. It'll be Freedom football. What a way to win a state title for Phoebus. Unbelievable. That'll be when we cut up and show you later on the NFHS Network.
How about a freshman, Marikus Banks, going 86 yards to Keontae Gray, the senior, in his last game. That's his final play. Very reminiscent of Jacob Thomas to Zeke Wimbush a couple years ago at ODU as Stonebridge beat Maury, which is coming up after this one.
Here's Evans. Going to keep it straight ahead for a couple yards. It'll be second down and about seven. Yeah, Maury Stonebridge set the kickoff at 5 o'clock. Again, different times this year. Earlier start and a later start for the second game. Earlier start for the first one at 11:30. We don't mind.
No, we don't.
We love doing these games. These are the best games of the year right here.
That's what high school football is all about here, is Freedom tries to milk this clock. You don't think of Freedom having the milking clock ability because they're known to stay pedal to the metal, go, 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 but now it's important.
Overton running to the right side, breaks the tackle, has got a first down and more, and it's all the way down past midfield. See, they say he ran out of bounds at the 40, but that play looked like there was nothing there. Watch it. I mean, it's just nothing. And he makes 10 yards out of it.
And what a crafty run. How many backs would have decided to cut it back? He knew where he was going from the start of that run. He sees the marker. He wants to move the chains and put this one away. He went into that run with a purpose of, I'm getting to the outside. You're not going to stop me. If he had to, he would have lowered the shoulder on our defender and got it done.
Tremendous talent. I mean, he's just a junior.
Just a junior. And like we said, coming in, he needed to break the Prince William rushing record for career. Tyquan Brown, a former Freedom player, ran for 6,768 yards from 2015 to 2018. He needed 679 to do that. Well, today he's over 200 yards. So going into his senior year, he can get that record within game two or three, right?
Maybe game one. You never
know. If he wants, yeah. Might depend who they play game one, but.
I mean, I would have to assume. And again, you know this better than I do because you follow the recruiting closely, but I would have to assume he's the number one player in the state of Virginia next year coming out.
Well, it's funny. A lot of college coaches are wondering who the best back is. You've got Gideon Davidson for Liberty Christian who's playing in the Class 3 state title game against Lafayette. Oh, by the way, he's going to play for Dabo Swinney and Clemson. You've got Harry Dalton, who's a quarterback that will play running back in college from Dinwiddie. You have Javon Ford from Kings Fork. But, yeah, I'm not going to pick someone ahead of Overton, I'll tell you that much, because –
based on what I've seen today, not only can he play on the offensive side of the ball, but he's a defensive player as well. I just don't know that there's a better overall player that I've seen. And you mentioned a couple tremendous runners and a quarterback. Dalton's a great player. Coach Mills got a really talented group coming back. But I don't know, man. Number six to me is just a different guy. And he's done this against a really good Highland Springs defense. That's one thing that it's very, very difficult to put in words how strong Coach Johnson's defenses are and have been at Highland Springs. They're typically dominant against the run. You do not get to run all over them like this.
No.
So when you see a young man doing what he's done here today, jumping over guys, you know, stiff-arming dudes, I mean, it's just you got to put your respect out there and say, look, this guy's a different player. And you got to credit that offensive line, too, and the receivers and how they block for him. I mean, he's certainly had a lot of help, but he's got some different skill sets that you don't see very often in high school.
Another final to tell you about, Andy Radford defeated Riverheads 39-21 in the Class 2 state championship.
Wow.
So that
big upset there.
15-0 win for them, and the Bobcats get the state title as the Gladiators end up seeing their streak of consecutive state titles come to an end at 7.
First down for Freedom. They'll move the chains and keep the clock going. There's Preston. Good to see him back in. Actually, he's going to be a little bit shy, it looks like. Fourth down and one coming up. He started to move the chains and then put him back there. So fourth down You know, Matt, this might be a preview of what we see next year. Evans, right? He's a senior. We might see Overton in the backfield running the show. Oh, this running play is stuffed on fourth and one. It'll be Highland Springs football.
This thing's not over yet. They're going to get the football now.
Johnson again.
Well, we talked about it. They're not used to having to kill the clock because they're usually so far ahead of teams. Their closest game this year was the 8-point win over Verona, but every other game, Andy, has been a win by basically 35-plus points, running clock margin. So
big hit right there by Brennan Johnson. Gives the football back to his team.
And what this enables, Andy, for Highland Springs to do, if they score within a reasonable amount of time, they don't have to onside kick because they have three timeouts. Freedom has no timeouts left. Well, they have, I think, maybe one, maybe none. So, you know, they have the time on their side.
Martin going to toss it underneath, caught by Finney Jr. He's got the first down, and he's out of bounds at the 24. Nifty play there by Christian Martin.
Finney, just the fourth leading receiver on the team with 14 catches coming in. But watch Martin step up in the pocket. Little scoot to the right, and Finney's got a lot of green grass in front of him. Getting some blocking from Henley on the outside. That's what you have to do to win a championship. Sacrifice, be selfless. Henley making the block there. And with 4:46 to go, the running game has been pretty much stopped. So it's going to be all throw unless Martin buys some time and takes off.
Here's Martin back to pass. Throwing it towards the end zone for Henley. Did he catch it?
Oh, no. I thought he got it.
Almost a sensational grab by Kyrie Henley. We got to watch that again.
Yeah, the official was pretty sure that it hit the ground. It might have. It might have taken a hop.
Slow it down even more once we get close here. This might have trumped Preston's if he'd caught this.
Oh, it did hit the ground.
It hit the ground. Yeah. Good call by the official who was right there.
Would have been a sensational reception.
It was a good throw by Martin. It was only where he could catch it.
And those are the safe throws you have to make if you're a quarterback that's headed to the Big Ten. Right now, he's going to have to stay poised here, locked in.
There's Martin back to pass. He'll take it and run. Got some room, and he's still on his feet. He might score. Christian Martin, touchdown, Springers. 4:28 to play. It's not over yet.
Look at Christian Martin. Again, determination, sheer will, not going to be denied here today. He cuts it back the other way, and Courtney delivered a shot to him up high, and his big frame's willing to take it. This is a young man that won a state basketball championship a few years ago, trying to get back-to-back as a football player to close out his career, and a decorated one at that. Still in it.
Extra point is good. We got an 8-point game. Go back and watch that run one more time by Christian Martin. Again, we talked about utilizing his legs here in the second half. Here you go. Nothing open downfield. Takes off and runs. Takes a shot. Stays on his feet. Dives to the end zone. And you never know. Springer magic. We've seen it for many years. Down by 8 with 4.5 to play.
And like I mentioned a few moments ago, Andy, with 4.5 minutes to go and all three timeouts, you do not have to onside kick it, and I wouldn't, because if you do and don't get the onside kick, now you're leaving Freedom with pretty good field position. They can chew up a lot of clock. I'm kicking it deep playing defense. Your defense has been, outside of a couple plays, really rock solid here in the second half. And it's hard to believe that with 42 points allowed. So.
What a game this has turned into. And one thing about it, you talk about winning close games, Highland Springs has played in games like this in championships where they've had to come back and win it in the end. Freedom has really not had to play a lot of close games here, Matt.
Yeah.
How do they respond if all of a sudden Highland Springs has the ball with a chance to tie the game, right? Key question. What a game. High kick. It'll be fielded back at the 15. And Reed will run it out of bounds at about the 26, 27-yard line.
Well, people wanted this matchup for months and months and months, and we got it. And if 76 points wasn't enough for you, guess what? There might still be some more points scored here in these last 4 minutes and change.
It's So it'll be first and 10.
Defense!
4:26 here on the clock here in this one.
Preston back out there in motion.
Quick toss to the edge. Here comes Reed. Out to about the 37-yard line. That'll be a first down.
And just the design to have Preston go in motion, I think, helps set this play up. You see him going to the top of the screen. They make the catch. He's out there ready to make a block on one of the defensive backs for Highland Springs. Gets to DeMontez Bullet Coles. And that's a really healthy gain to move the sticks for your freedom. You'll take that every time.
So first down and 10 for Freedom. They're milking some clock here. Evans back in the ball game. He'll keep it. Running to the right. Tackled at the 47, let's call it, 48-yard line. He's going to be about a yard shy of the first down.
You know, Evans has been quiet in the second and third quarters of this game, but trying to finish it off strong the way he began the ball game, set the tempo for Freedom. Another first down will force Highland Springs to use one of those timeouts.
So second and short here. Again, clock winding, and you kind of assume if they get the first down here, Matt, that the next run, you're going to have to call a timeout for Highland Springs.
Absolutely.
There's Overton bouncing inside for a first down carry to the 44 of Highland Springs.
This guy's a different breed. We've talked about it all day long, gushing and gushing about him. And he's really been everywhere on this football field. He's played defense. They've gone to some different formations where he's handed off the football. And you think about this Freedom offense. How good is it, Andy? They set the state scoring record last year, averaging almost 60 a game this year. Highland Springs hadn't allowed 40-plus points in a football game since 2013.
Unreal.
When Atlee put up 49 on them. So we're talking about something that hadn't happened in 10 years, and they did it today and made it look easy.
Almost a tackle in the back door. Overton's got some running room, still on his feet. First down carries out of bounds. And he's limping a little bit. What a run.
Again, he gets to the outside. He knows where he wants to go. When he makes his mind up on a run, there's no need to do the cutting and zigging and zagging and juking. You run with power, purpose, persistence. With 2:14 to play, Freedom knows they're closing in on some history here and going back-to-back undefeated seasons. And to beat a very worthy challenger in Highland Springs who won the title a year ago in Class 5 at Old Dominion. We watched them beat Maury. Maury Johnson's program came fighting back to try to make it 6 championships in 9 years, but they're going to need some miraculous turn of events to have a shot in these last couple of minutes.
They got to start using these timeouts after this first down run if they can get a stop here and keep them from gaining a first down. You're going to have to hope for a mistake maybe by Freedom. Handoff again, Overton. Overton for a first down run. Mouthpiece comes out. Big hit by Johnson, but that moves the chains again. I don't know why you wouldn't do the same thing over and over again. Right now, Overton's averaging about 12 yards a carry in this situation.
Bad wheel, mouthpiece out. He doesn't care. He wants to win. He's hungry for a second ring. I think he knows the perspective of what he can do and accomplish before he moves on to college, you know, in a couple years. He wants to be one of the all-time running backs in Virginia High School League history, and there's a great long laundry list of them.
Under 2 minutes to play here in the state championship game. First and 10. And that's going to be a false start penalty on Freedom. So that will stop the clock and move them back 5 yards. The one thing I would say to you, Matt, in just watching Jeff Overton run, I used to say this about Reggie Bush,
Michael Vick. I mean, they look so effortless and like they're not even trying to run hard, and yet they're faster than most everybody on the field.
It's like they're gliding out there and they're skating on ice, and you're playing in quicksand trying to catch them. It's just, and these defenders for Highland Springs, they're no joke. We talked about it. This is the first time in 10 years they've been hit for this many points and I'm sure this many yards. I mean, they're probably closing in on close to 500 now in this game.
First and 15, Evans is going to keep it, and he's going to be pulled down. And now the timeout will be called by Coach Johnson with a minute and 30 on the clock.
It's all about ball secure at this point. Don't put it on the carpet. Let it pop loose. Freedom takes care of the football. They're going to win this football game and finish off a 14-0 season and a second straight state championship. And think about this. Of their 29 victories in a row, all but two of them will, it appears to be, you know, double digits unless they score here. It could be 28 of them. They had the one tussle with Verona this year. It was a one-score, single-digit game, and this one right now is at single digits, but I don't think Freedom's thinking about scoring. They just want to run the clock out. You say, why not? Two TDs puts it up. Well, it still allows Highland Springs to get the ball, try an onside kick if they were to score a touchdown. Freedom right now wants to end this game and run the clock out.
Second and 15. Handoff in the backfield. This one to Cameron Courtney. Straight ahead for a couple, another timeout. Clock at 1:25. So now it's going to be third down and about 14 here for Freedom.
Just two fantastic programs. I don't think we can talk about it enough, what Daryl Overton's done at Freedom and Lauren Johnson at Highland Springs to put their teams in position to repeat in the highest classification in Virginia high school football. Springer's moving up from Class 5. The Eagles of Woodbridge, who, you know, played some teams. They had one game that was middle of the year, Andy, or early in the year, halts because of weather with DeMatha. They were winning that game, ended up not getting resumed, but played Coolidge out of D.C. They're trying to challenge themselves against other teams outside of Woodbridge, and Highland Springs has been known to do that outside of Richmond for years and years and years.
So third and 14. Overton's going to take it to the right side. Johnson trying to track him down. They knock him out of bounds, so they save a timeout. Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah, clock shouldn't keep running. He was out of bounds,
he was
clearly
out of bounds.
I'm not sure what that official is signaling the clock keeps running for. Is he saying his forward progress was stopped on the hit? Can't be.
That doesn't make any sense. I mean, the clock is still running. They got a timeout. They got to call timeout.
I think they're out.
Are they out?
I think they're out.
I mean, he was still running when he ran the ball
out
of bounds.
That clock should have stopped there. And I'm surprised Lauren Johnson isn't a tad bit more animated. I think he realizes now Freedom will use its last timeout with 33 seconds. And the decision here, Andy, I don't think you dare try a field goal because it could get blocked and then all heck could break loose. Craziness could ensue. Could be Alabama-Auburn part two, if you will. And the one with the kick, not the fourth and goal from the 31 that got this year's Crimson Tide to the college football playoff with Michigan and with Washington. And
I don't know. We still had him down as having one timeout, Matt.
Yeah.
Left.
You know, Texas, by the way. Yeah, I'm not sure. I know the board up here up top was showing no. Now, that could have been after they assumed they were calling one, but he clearly looked like he was out of bounds. I don't know how said that the time would continue on. And you would think that maybe one of his official teammates would go over to him and say, no, clock stopped.
Right.
They didn't go over to help. Now, he's got the closest angle of it.
Because that took off another 30 seconds there.
Valuable for Highland Springs here, because if you're Freedom, I think Daryl Overton's thinking what I was saying. You don't try a field goal at all here. And the other thing is, I wouldn't even throw this ball, because if you throw this ball into the end zone or anywhere near it, Could be a pick six deal.
Yeah, Overton, to me, is the guy. Give him the ball and see what he can do.
And it's going to be him out of Wildcat, it looks like.
Fourth down and nine. They'll hand it, a reverse back to Preston. Got a block in front, and he's out of bounds. No first down. It'll be Highland Springs football.
It's a good job by Highland Springs giving themselves a chance, though it is a long shot. And how about Overton to hand it off and still go out there and block? How many backs would just got out of the way, or even quarterbacks if he's the one handing off here? Little razzle-dazzle read back to Preston. He's looking to throw a block there. And a good job by the defender. I think that was number nine for Highland Springs, Devin Simmons, to not take that bait. He shook it off, and because if he gets blocked there, it might allow him to get to the edge there and get the first down.
So Highland Springs with 26 seconds to play.
Can they go get Marikus Banks and Keontae Gray from Lynchburg and have them come for this play?
Right, for one play, right?
Tell you what.
Freshman will be a legend in the hallways on Monday.
If we get 93 yards here.
Martin kind of hesitated. I don't know if he got a handle on the ball. Remember, it's been raining out there.
It might have slipped out.
Yeah, it looked like it maybe slipped out of his grip.
Well, in reality, if he gets a short gain and gets tackled, the clock's running. So
right.
That's a blessing if, you know, now if he catches it and he gets out of bounds. These all have to be the sideline because anything in the middle of the field in a tackle, you're basically scrambling to get a heave off. But this is going to have to be a make you miss play and slipping a guy and making the Freedom defenders who are so fast and athletic miss inside your own 10. That's a big ask.
Coach Johnson wanted a new football out there. He needed the ball boy over here on the near side to get him a new one. Well, here we go, second and 10. Quick toss. Out of bounds is Loveless. So third and one for Highland Springs. 17 seconds to play.
Again, it's hard to throw a Hail Mary, chuck and pray type of play at this spot of the field.
Let's go, Springers! Let's go!
No timeouts left for Highland Springs.
Let's go! Let's go, Springers!
Martin will toss it up. This one caught for a first down out to about the 29, 30-yard line. So they'll get a fresh set of downs with 9 seconds, and really right here you got to start challenging down the field to get within striking distance, right? You throw it up and have a shot at maybe a Hail Mary.
Yeah, with 9 seconds to go, or if you have one of those hook and ladder Boise State or Cal Stanford plays in the bag, one of those razzle dazzle where you have some laterals, this could require lateraling the ball after you make a completion.
Martin back to pass. Throws it, and that might run the clock out right there. No time left, and that's it. Freedom celebrates back-to-back state championships. As the clock hits zero, the Eagles soar to a 42-34 victory.
This one had so many momentum swings, Andy. Highs and lows for both teams and just some great plays, and many of them made by juniors on the field for both sides. In the case of Freedom, 29 straight wins for Darryl Overton's team. Hats off to them for accomplishing this feat, knowing it would not be easy, and they didn't blink even when the Springers came roaring back.
Tremendous win. Great game. We weren't expecting it to be somewhat close, but that's a credit to Highland Springs and their championship history. They never quit. They were right there the whole time. And a couple plays here and there, Matt, and they could have been right there for a late win. But you really got to credit Freedom. They just kept doing what they do, and Jeff Overton and crew found a way to get a big run or two, big pass play. And there was never a doubt in their mind They had it. They got their second state championship ring.
We talk a lot of times. We talk a lot of times, Andy, about state championships not being won in the first quarter. They can be lost, but you know, Highland Springs came roaring back. I will say this: the Freedom defense in the first quarter to keep Highland Springs out of the end zone. They got 13 points those last 7 minutes, but to jump out to that 28-point lead, because after the first, you know, 16 minutes of this one, and again, it takes 48 minutes, but it was all Freedom, 28-0, and that big lead. Sometimes it's hard to finish the deal, making the comeback all the way from four TDs down. Jeffrey Overton was spectacular, and if you haven't seen his plays, make sure you go back and watch it here on the NFHS Network. Cameron Courtney, he stepped up. The crazy TD pass to Juju Preston, the one-handed snag. I mean, really, Freedom wins this game with two second-half touchdowns. That was it. But they were big clutch touchdowns to keep the opposition at bay. A lot of heart and pride shown by Highland Springs. They'll be back in the mix as long as Lauren Johnson is the coach. He's got a son to coach, keep coaching, and Brennan Johnson, the linebacker. We'll have to replace Christian Martin at quarterback, but I look up and down the Freedom roster, Andy, outside of Tristan Evans, the senior, and you got E.J. Reed and Cam Courtney, also seniors, Jewel Harris, Isaiah Harper, Aaron Duncan. There are so many juniors and key cogs coming back for them. Jonah Fuga on the line, Preston and Overton, and there'll be a handful.
Well, this has been one of the most prolific scoring teams in VHSL history. And they put 42 up today, which was just enough to hold off Highland Springs.
Well, again, if they didn't have that fast start that they got off to, they might have been on the wrong side of this one. It was imperative for them to jump out and not allow Highland Springs to have, you know, a chance to keep this within striking distance, which they had in the second half, but they had to work so hard to make it a competitive ball game.
Before we join the public address announcer for the championship trophy presentations, it's time for us to choose our Academy Sports and Outdoors player of the game. And no question for me, Matt, and I'm sure you too, it's Jeff Overton, the junior tailback today with an unbelievable performance. He had 164 yards in the first half alone. Couple touchdowns. We saw him throw a touchdown today to his teammate Carlton Preston. I mean, just a tremendous overall performance by number six, Jeff Overton. And he's coming back for more next year. So all the coaches in the area just said, oh no.
Yeah, that Prince William County record could be in sight. I think he could very well be named Class 6 State Offensive Player of the Year for the second straight season. They'll be thinking about a three-peat. And a lot of honorable mentions you could put up there as worthy candidates, certainly on the line. Walter Hughes, big center, paving the way for him. He was impressive. Juju Preston with that one-handed snag. Can't forget about Cam Courtney. Ja'Kai Hughes with a pick six and some key plays for Highland Springs. Brennan Johnson at linebacker number 11 was everywhere. Ja'Kari Henley number one. But Jeff Overton was a cut above the rest here today and very deserving of that honor. And I think he's going to be player of the game, player of the year for years to come. And his future is so bright. And like you said too, Andy, he's not a one-trick pony. You can flex him out to receiver and at defensive back. He's very, very skilled as well.
We'll take a quick break here and a quick word from Academy Sports and Outdoors. We'll be right back with the championship trophy presentations after this.
This presentation of the NFHS Network is brought to you by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Have fun out there.
With great brands at the best prices at Academy Sports and Outdoors, you'll always find more fun. More of this and this. And more of this and this. So you can do more of that. And that. And that. And definitely some of that. While getting together for more of that. That. And that. Yes! Have more fun with great brands at the best prices only at Academy Sports and Outdoors.
This presentation of the NFHS Network is brought to you by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Have fun out there.
We With great brands at the best prices at Academy Sports and Outdoors, you'll always find more fun. More of this and this. And more of this and this. So you can do more of that. And that. And that. And definitely some of that. While getting together for more of that. That. And that. Yes! Have more fun with great brands at the best prices. Only at Academy Sports and Outdoors.
This presentation of the NFHS.
And we welcome you back here. Braxton. Andy Hayes alongside
Elijah Williams. Number four, Noah Jenkins.
Matt Hatfield will join the public address announcer for the championship presentation.
Number six, Jamin Lewis. Number seven, Ezekiel Burchett. Number eight, Diamantes Bullet Coles. Number nine, Devin Simmons. Number 11, Brennan Johnson. Number 12, Christian Martin. Number 13, Corey Gray Jr. Number 13, George Lovelace. Number 14, Ray Varner. Number 15, Jarrell Dent. Number 16, Christian Forrest. Number 17, Anthony Hansen. Number 18, Andre Torrell. Number 19, Kevin Finney Jr. Number 20, Marion Harvey. Number 21, Altianzano Edwards. Number 22, Eric Bird. Number 23, Kamal Fountain. Number 24, Kasim Drungle. Number 25, Carter Reed. Number 26, Christian Basma. Number 27, Jeffrey Gershaw. Number 28, Diego Enriquez. Number 29, Kalik Saunders. Number 30, Jonathan Massenberg II. Number 31, Deron Ferguson. Number 32, Femi Inkamfola. Number 33, Larry Johnson. Number 34, Josiah Martinez. Number 35, Cameron Davis. Number 36, Dewan Basso. Number 37, Harvey Anderson. Number 38, Shamari Hollingsworth. Number 39, Jarice Alston. Number 40, Damari Brooks. Number 41, Evan Ford. Number 42, Rakeek Hopkins. Number 43, Deontay Webb Jr. Number 44, Roshan Street. Number 45, Robert Jackson. Number 46, Malik Bullock. Number 47, Kenneth Lawson. Number 48, Devin Nelson. Number 49, Jaden Parker. 50, Dominic Washington. Number 51, Ethan Bragg. 52, Nicholas Jones. 53, Timothy Jones. Number 54, Caden Brown. Number 55, Bryson Brethwaite. Number 56, Charzell Evans. 57, Jaden Schuler. Number 58, Raquan Taylor. 60, Eliza Johnson. 61, Roosevelt Baptiste. 65, Mejo Ba. Number 66, Dallas Wells. Number 70, Takai Alexander. Number 71, Jayon Morgan. 72, Javier Frazier. Number 74, John Cassidy. Number 75, Damari Lassiter. Also number 75, Samuel Twyman. Number 76, Chase Wilkerson. Number 77, Michael Becton. Number 80, Amir McKee. Number 81, Jaden Brown. 82, DeJuan Green. 83, Zamar Bledsoe. Number 84, Jalen Padmore. Number 85, Ronell Knight. Number 86, Antoine Richardson. Number 87, Jeremy Henley. 88, Christian Bowler. 89, Henry Hazelgrove. Number 90, Mion Morris. 91, Hezekiah Fox. Number 92, Anthony Barrett. Number 95, Demir McEachin. Number 99, Joshua Clayton. Once again, congratulations to the Highland Springers. Coach Lauren Johnson, assistant coaches William Alston, Ryan Anderson, Travis Bell, Russell Charity, Marquise Crawford, Kevin Dent, Derek Hopkins, Robbie Jackson, Jerron Jackson, DJ Johnson, Keelan Mayo, Vel Perry, Gerard Richards, Tynan Rolander, Puka Scott, Devin Simmons, Ralph Stavell, Chris Thaxton, Jordan Wall, and Larry Williams. Once again, congratulations to Highland Springs on a phenomenal season.
That's what you wait. I can tell you're still waiting on something. I was like, that's what.
So Highland Springs falls a little bit short here today. The Class 6 state runner-up, but a valiant effort. And congrats again to Coach Johnson and his team on a great season. And they'll be back, no doubt about it. And now we'll join the public address announcer for the championship trophy presentations to the Freedom Eagles.
Once again, congratulations to Freedom High School, the Class 6 VHSL Championship. Presenting the VHSL Class 6 Championship medals and trophy to the Eagles are the VHSL Assistant Director Chris Robinson, Montreal High School Director Matthew Pierman, Principal Chevelli Smith, and Athletic Director Thomas Anazuta-Ziata. Members of the Eagles. Number 1, Carlton Preston. Number 2, Marquis Dawkins. Number 4, Elijah Reed. Number 5, Cameron Courtney. Number 6, Jeff Overton. Number 7, Ja'Kai Jackson Hughes. Number 8, Joel Harris. Number 9, Isaiah Harper. Number 10, Devin Reeves. Number 11, Aaron Duncan. Number 12, Tristan Evans Trujillo. Number 13, Derek Moore. Number 14, Kyrie Bullock. Number 15, Daryl Fancy. Number 17, Tyson Washington. Number 18, Caleb Tucker. Number 20, Carmine Stanley. Number 21, Raymond Rodriguez. Number 22, Isaiah Shalapoka. Number 23, Dazon Howard. Number 24, Kevin Daquan Lovard. Number 27, Benjamin Kanodu Sarfa. Number 28, Jaden Taylor. Number 30, Caleb Clemens. Number 31, Tyson Haddon. Number 31, Dallas Jackson. Number 32, Alpha Kento. Number 33, Divine Sedonu. Number 34, Braxton Hunt. Number 40, Justice Gordon. Number 44, Jaden Austin. Number 51, Justin Robinson. Number 52, Demontre Adams. Number 53, Mao Talay. Number 55, Joel Stanley Jackson. Number 56, Amari Cooper. Number 58, Jonah Fuga. Number 62, Marcus Cox. Number 63, Michael Barrera Lopez. Number 63, Alicine Conte. Number 63, Alejandro Ventura Cortez. Number 70, Michael Mendizabel Perez. Number 71, Dalen King. Number 72, Jamal Gibbs. Number 75, Donovan Lewis. Number 77, Walter Hughes. Number 81, Marquis Stevenson. Number 84, Antonio Elam. Number 88, Marquetta Stevenson. Number 99, Kelly Timone. Coaches for the Eagles, head coach, Daryl Overton. Assistant coaches, Cody Williams, Greg Johnson, Chris Davis, Tony Mooney, Chris Cousins, Baron Taylor, Jeff Overton, and Charles Gates. Once again, congratulations to the Freedom High School Eagles, Class 6 state champions of the Virginia High School League.
So the Highland Springs Springers fall today to the Freedom Eagles, your 2023 VHSL Class 6 state champions for the second year in a row. Division 6 runs through Freedom Woodbridge. And that'll do it for our production here today. Congrats to Coach Overton and his staff and the kids from the Freedom Eagles football team on another great season. We are just about out of here, folks. We'll leave you with the run of the day, the play of the day from Jeff Overton. A tremendous effort here this afternoon. Our Academy Sports and Outdoors player of the game. What a performance here as the Eagles on a 4th-and-1. This kind of set the tone on how it was going to be today. Number 6 showing some magic here on this run. Congratulations to the Freedom Eagles. For Helene Shane, our producer, Jack Hayes, our graphics man, helping us on the broadcast as well. For Matt Hatfield, my partner up here, Ryan Dugerta, our top cameraman, and Owen Hayes down on the sideline. We'll see you next time here. Stay tuned for the 5 o'clock start of the Division 5 state championship coming up here in a little while.
He's going to take it himself for a championship! Oh. A double play wins it!
Turn it to the end zone. What a catch! McCoy's on touchdown.
Into the way.